Good Saturday evening, Eagle fans, and welcome to Moscow, Idaho, inside the Kibbe Dome here on the campus of the University of Idaho, site of tonight's Sun Belt Conference opener between the Idaho Vandals and your Georgia Southern Eagles. Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair alongside Terry Harvin, Danny Reed, Russ Brown, Colin Lacey on hand here to get set to bring you tonight's play-by-play story. Eagles travel over 2,100 miles. They've got another trek back to Statesboro late tonight. Hopefully, they'll be taking their first Sun Belt Conference win of the season back with them. But we've got plenty of football here as we're just moments away from getting started as the Eagles face the Vandals for the third time in school history. The Eagles have a 2-0 record, playing back in 1999 in the playoffs, and then, of course, last year's win back in Paulson Stadium, 47-24. Georgia Southern and Idaho, the captains, met at the 50-yard line. Idaho won the toss. They decided they wanted to take the football. So the Eagles will kick it off to the Vandals. Coach Petrino and company will try to see what they have offensively. After getting by with a big win last week over the Wofford Terriers, it was a close one. They were able to get the win 41-38. In fact, Idaho here tonight trying to go for back-to-back wins for the first time since 2009. The win last Saturday here in the Kibbe Dome broke a six-game losing streak. The last time they had won at home was October 18th of last year, and a 29-17 win over New Mexico State. For Georgia Southern, no problem with the Citadel at home last week, 48-13. Come into the matchup 2-1 on the season, but this one, the biggest game of the season. It's a conference game, and the game that's on the schedule this week. Vandals come from the near sideline. The Eagles now break from the far sideline. Eagles dressed in their road white, white jerseys, blue numerals, white pants, Georgia Southern blue helmets for the homestanding Vandals. They'll be in black tops, gold numerals, gold trim, gold pants, black high socks, black helmets with gold stripes. Elijah Penny and Aaron Duckworth, the combo in the backfield, will be back deep to receive this kickoff. Alex Hanks will have the honors. First half kickoff presented by Georgia Farm Bureau and your Georgia Farm Bureau agent since 1959, serving the interest and insurance needs of Georgia residents and Georgia residents only. Here's the approach. Boot meets ball. We've got football here in Idaho. Deep kick. Back of the end zone. Hits the back wall. It'll be a touchback. Idaho will start first down and 10 from their own 25-yard line. Interesting sight lines here inside the Kibbe Dome. We sit at about the 33-yard line across the way from the Georgia Southern bench. Goalposts are mounted into the back walls on both ends. And what do you think, Terry? 8 yards from the back of the end zone to the wall?
Yeah, about that. You're right. Kind of close to arena football. There's plenty of distance, though. And Idaho's ready to go.
So Matt Linehan will bring the troops out. Sophomore quarterback, baptized by fire last year in Petrino's offense. Started in all games and already 13th all-time in Idaho passing with passing yards in a career. He'll open up, trip receivers left, two to the right side and an empty backfield, and no one there to help block, and the Eagles get an early sack on first down. Bernard Dawson and Jamal Johnson. With four men up front, they just eat up the offensive front of the Vandals and get to Linehan and bring him down for a loss on the opening play, a loss of five. It'll be second and 15.
We immediately come back with Darius Sapp and Jay Ellison to bring them in the ball game, and now we're back to that traditional 4-3 defense.
Linehan will move under center, this time with a single back. Elijah Penny, two receivers right. Give to Penny, he'll come up the middle. Pick up some of that lost yardage as Chris De La Rosa grabs on, holds on, stops him shy of the 23-yard line. So not much of a pickup there. Sets up third and long right out of the gate. Third and 12 upcoming for the Vandals. Penny had 19 carries, just under 100 yards last week in the win over Wofford. But Aaron Duckworth, who will see time in that offensive backfield, he's the sophomore running back. He had the touchdowns, had three against Wofford last week. Expect to see both of them back there, but Linehan now will spread the field. Two receivers right, one to the left side. Tight end just off the line to the right. Penny back there in the backfield. It's the shotgun snap on third and 12. Linehan's going to run. Shows some hops, goes right side, cuts back left. Flag down at the 22-yard line. There's an Eagle slow to get up as well, but nowhere close to the first down. It'll be fourth and about six upcoming. Logan Hunt, the player for the Eagles, slow to get up. He's on his back. It looks like holding going against the Vandals here, so they'll get to repeat third down, but they'll get to tack some yards on an already long third down opportunity.
Offense, number 55. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
I was thinking he might decline it because we're putting the Idaho in a situation to have to punt. I don't know if I wanted to give him another shot for a third down conversion, long yardage with a passing. A little different look we're giving the Idaho Vandals to start this ball game. We came in with a three-man front with three linebackers. We immediately rotate, get them out. We bring in the big hog, Sapp and Ellison. We go back to our traditional 4-3, but then walk up a linebacker with a blitz. This last play on third and long, come back with a three-man front with the three linebackers.
Still taking a look down on the field to Logan Hunt. While we have a moment, let's get that station identification to stations across the network lines. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. So Hunt being helped off after going down on the turf after the last play. Looks to be his left leg. He's being helped by the training crew to that far sideline. Rather, the right leg is a little ginger as he walks off. We'll check in with Danny Reed after the training crew gets a look at Logan Hunt. Derek Keaton will set back for the ensuing punt that will come our way. He stands at the 25-yard line, and maybe the best weapon that Idaho has in their arsenal is Austin Rico. Kicks and punts, and he'll be out there to punt this away, standing right now at his own 15-yard line, kicking this one right to left on your dial. So Rico awaits, as does Keaton. Here's the snap. Eagles come after it, and it's blocked down on the field, and Rico trying to pick it up and run. He'll be dropped at the 15-yard line. Wow, they got in. Looked like Ironhead Gallon. Deshante got in for the block. Rico quickly found the football, had nothing else to do but try and run. He was cut down at the 15-yard line. So Rico suffers a terrible blow. First block of the season against the junior punter. And it sets up the Eagles inside the clubhouse red zone at the Idaho 15-yard line. And special teams, as I mentioned, Coach Petrino talked about it all week. That's one of their strong suits, but the Eagles turn it the other way in this opening drive.
He just took, not only did Ironhead get off the ball quickly and had a good angle, but the punter, Rico, took too long to get rid of it. Heads up play to get on the ball, or it could have been six. Great position for the Eagles, Chris, as Ellison brings us out with Rita.
Kevin Ellison maybe has gotten the rust off of him after playing the majority of the game last week. First down and 10 from the 15. Ellison going to keep left side. Gets away from one defender, and a shoestring tackle brings him down just shy of the 10-yard line. It was Armin Hawkins making the tackle. But Ellison showing his shifty ability out there. And a good job of selling on the handoff. Idaho crashed right down the middle of the lane and allowed him some room on the left edge. Pick up a four. It'll be second down and six. Breida on the wing to the right side of Ellison. Time Breida gets the carry, he'll bounce it out to the left side. Vandals giving chase, trying to get a piece of the jersey, and eventually runs out of room far side. But may have lost yardage back around the 15. Good coverage by Brock Westlake, the middle linebacker. Looked like Breida was going to be hemmed up at the line. Somehow able to keep himself upright. Try to bounce it, find some room, but ran into the boundary. So the Eagles now find themselves back at third and 10. 43% on third down this season. Ellison will send two receivers to the right. Two to the left side. Longoria the wide out to the left. Miles Campbell in the slot left side. Now Miles will motion before the snap. Ellison takes it. Nowhere to go, and he'll be brought down from behind at the 15-yard line. Went right. Trying to set up the option with Campbell as the pitch man, but Idaho had it covered. He had to cut back to his left, nowhere to go. And the Eagles will have to go for a field goal here after getting great field position after a block punt. But credit Idaho. Defensively, they were in position, made the tackles.
Yeah, great penetration by Idaho there. Kevin couldn't do anything with it. Now Hanks is out, Chris, to try a 33-yarder.
Matt Dobson will hold from the far side hash. Placement down, kick on its way. And the kick is good. So the Eagles get points After a great special teams play to set them up inside the clubhouse red zone, they wanted a touchdown. They'll settle for the field goal, and they take a 3-0 lead with 11:38 to go here in the first quarter. We'll take a timeout, return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. First quarter action inside the Kibbe Dome here in Moscow, Idaho. Georgia Southern leading 3-0 on an Alex Hanks field goal. Fans get impressive fuel economy without sacrificing power when you drive the 2015 Ford F-150 or Fusion, available with EcoBoost technology. And right now you can get great lease options or big cashback savings on the full lineup of cars, trucks, and SUVs with EcoBoost at your local Ford dealer. Proud sponsor of Georgia Southern football. And Terry, you want that opportunity after special teams gives you, really serves it up on a platter on a block punt. Ball recovered at the 15-yard line, but credit Idaho. They're shutting the door. And eventually Alex Hanks having to come on to kick the field goal. But impressive. Idaho looks like they know where they're supposed to be defensively.
Yeah, and they know what they need to do as far as penetration, which is exactly what they did. Ironhead comes in, blocks a punt, puts the Eagles great field position at the 15. Ellison takes the opening play there on a dive or keeper to the left, which is uncharacteristic of them because usually they hand it off in the first play to Breida or someone. Good yardage after that. It was backwards. Hanks comes in with a 33-yard field goal to put the Eagles up 3-0, but importantly, able to get points on the board after a turnover. Brought to you by the Domino's Pizza Drive Delivery. Brought to you by Domino's, Chris.
Alex Hanks to kick this one left to right. Puts a foot in this one, end over end, spinning kick. Will be fielded 2 yards deep by Aaron Duckworth. He'll come up the far side hash. Now shake to the outside at the 15 and then brought down at the 20-yard line. So that's where Idaho will take over. Georgia Southern football proudly sponsored by Bud Light, the perfect beer when you're up for whatever. Bud Light reminds you to always drink responsibly. While we have a moment, go down on the field. Danny Reed, we saw Logan Hunt have to be helped off, and you told us in the break, B.J. Johnson also having to have a look through.
Chris, for Logan Hunt, it's a right ankle. He's going to try to give it a go. Not out there currently, but he should be back at some point during the first half. B.J. Johnson's got the wind knocked out of him. He's fine.
Thanks, Danny. Here we are, first down at 10. Idaho back on the field, their second possession. Linehan will have Elijah Penning on a wing to the right side as they scrimmage from the far side hash. Snap in the gun. Design run for Linehan, who pulls from Penny and runs out of bounds as Matt Dobson forces him to the boundary at the 25-yard line, but a gain of 5. It'll be second down and 5, and for all the talk of Matt Linehan's arm, as we said, completing about 70% of his passes so far this season, also been known to scamper with the football as he picks up 5 yards there.
Good show speed there for him. Wasn't able to turn the corner. Good pursuit by Lenny Richardson.
They give him 4 yards, just shy of the 25. Comes out throwing to Penny in the flat. Had it, and ball knocked loose. What a hit by White. Penny had to go a little in the air, come back to his quarterback, and when he got his hands on it, the blow was delivered by Darius White, the 5'11 senior out of Belton, Texas. And about a half second more, and that would have been a fumble.
Timed it perfectly. Good clean hit. Jarred the ball away from him. We come back in with a three-man front. Three linebackers. All three are walking up close to the line of scrimmage.
So far this year, 33% are the Vandals on third down. Third down and 6 upcoming. Linehan will empty the backfield. Send two receivers. Short side of the field, that's the right. 2 to the left, fires, drag route, in the hands and incomplete at the 30-yard line. He was looking for Desmond Epps. Matt Dobson was right there on coverage. Good control by Dobson to stay away from the pass interference call. And Epps, that one thrown on a frozen rope from Linehan. Epps couldn't hold on.
Crowd certainly wanted pass interference on there. Thought Dobson broke on him a little too quickly. It was certainly very quick. Combination of Dobson hitting him with the ball was getting there. Glover hitting himself because he was almost there to have an INT.
So two possessions and 2 punts, it appears, as Rico back out there will stand at the 10-yard line where he was just a few moments ago when the Eagles came after him. They come after it again, but he gets this one away, and it's a mile high. Keaton calling for fair catch, gets under it, fields it at the 24-yard line. That's where the Eagles take over with 10:52 remaining. Here in the first quarter, the Eagles up 3-0. Braswell's Food Company, providing America with over 400 award-winning products like red pepper jelly, sweet balsamic onion jam, and smoky chipotle mustard. Braswell's has plenty of options to make your tailgate a success. So look for Braswell products in grocery stores and specialty shops across the nation or online at braswells.com. There's a timeout on the field. Georgia Southern has the football, first down and 10 at their own 24-yard line. They lead 3-0 over Idaho, and we'll return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. Listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Back with you in Moscow, Idaho, here on a Saturday evening. Georgia Southern leading over the Idaho Vandals, 3-0 early on, 10:52 remaining here in the first quarter. Eagles with the football, attacking left to right on your dial as they start first down and 10 from their own 24-yard line. Ellison has L.A. Ramsby in the backfield. Here's the pistol snap, little play action. Ellison looking to throw, far side, has a man. Johnson has to go down, and he hauls it in at the 42-yard line. Great play by B.J. Johnson, a little underthrown, way out on the far sideline, and Johnson just has a nose for it. Goes down, keeps it from hitting the turf, hauls it in cleanly, and a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
A little bit underthrown, as you mentioned, but thrown where only Johnson could make the catch, and he did come up with it. Good job getting his arms underneath it.
First down and 10, now at the Eagle 42-yard line. Ramsby in as the single back. Johnson the wide out to the left. Ramsby will get the carry, try to go left side. Straight ahead. Got to about the 43, only a one-yard gain. It'll be second down and 9 upcoming inside the dome here. A little chilly outside when the sun starts to set. Climate controlled here inside the Kibbe Dome. Told on Friday when we came over that the turf on its last legs, about 10, 11 years old, so they've gotten about as much as they're going to get out of the turf here before they have to replace it. Here's Ellison pulled from Breida and then tripped up, falls forward just shy of the 44-yard line of his very own. Chris Edwards making the tackle.
Well, I think he's going to go back against Idaho because Chris Edwards got a very good start. It may have been in our backfield before the snap was even done.
Offsides, defense, number 43, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
That always helps to get there quicker if you get a little jump. So the penalty against the Idaho Vandals. Officials presented by Vision Source and Dr. Horace Deal. Remember, when making the right call, your vision cannot be compromised. So schedule your appointment today with Vision Source and Dr. Horace Deal, the official team eye doctor of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Our referee, who you just heard from, Kevin Stein. Umpire, John Short. Martin Hawkins, our center judge. Scott Peterson, the linesman. Deion Quinn, the line judge. Field judge, Jamie Grant. Side judge, Bart Horn. Back judge, Jay Brown. And our replay official upstairs is Bill Merritt. Second down and 4. Eagles need to get to Vandal territory. This time on the handoff, Breida stood up at the line. Now breaks free far side into Vandal territory. He's got the Franklin first down at the 47-yard line of Idaho. Just wow. Second effort. That's the second time tonight he has refused to go down after being hit initially.
Drove Andy Kwan back a little bit. They fell down. Breida hits the backside of Andy Kwan on the ground. Looked like he was down. He's able to bounce out, take it to the left. And then Wesley Fields comes in to the check into the ball game with Rita.
They'll line up in the stack pistol eye here on first down and 10 now from the Idaho 47-yard line. Play action. Ellison going for the home run ball over the top, looking for Johnson, and he's mugged. No flag, and it's incomplete down around the 8-yard line. That's good coverage by Dorian Clark.
I like the pass. As we get to watch on a replay, beautiful pass out of that pistol. Hasn't seen that yet. Ooh, yeah, very, very good coverage. But could have gone either way, but very good coverage, step for step, but a great pass by Ellison.
Yeah, you don't want to see one of those underthrown.
And no.
The only man who had a chance was B.J. Johnson. It's incomplete, sets up second down 10 at the Idaho 47. Eagles second possession of the game. Ellison comes out firing in the flat, rifles this one, overthrown near side at the 40-yard line. He was looking for Derek Keaton. That one came out a little hot and incomplete, and that'll set up third down at 10 here.
Yeah, a little bit too high for him. As L.A. Ramsby's checking into the ball game, single back set, third down for the Eagles.
Critical third down here. The Eagles 0-for-1 on the day. They'll send two receivers left, two to the near side, and Keaton and Campbell. Campbell will be in the slot. Ramsby back there to block on third down and 10. Vandal fans trying to make noise here for the first time. Ellison with time, zips across the middle, gets it to Johnson. It's caught at the 35, and he rumbles his way down to the 30-yard line. It's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Jordan Grabski eventually able to hem up B.J. Johnson. But B.J. coming to play tonight, his second catch. And that one a big third down conversion, the first of the evening. And the Eagles drive stays alive deeper in Vandal territory now at the 30-yard line as Breida back in. May have been in the neutral zone here as they come after Ellison. Lets it fly. One-on-one coverage. Longoria trying to grab it. Pulls it out of the air. Nope. They'll say it was intercepted. Coming over the top. The Vandals pull it out of the air. Longoria came over the top of Dorian Clark, but could not pull it free from Clark. You can see it there. The ball just underthrown, and Clark got his hands on it. They say he stays in bounds on the far side, or rather near sideline. And the interception offered up.
You know, I think this is the fourth time it's happened.
An interception. The previous play is under further review.
Well, because they thought once again it was offsides, and so therefore they thought he jumped in the neutral zone. They snap it quickly. Everybody stands up, and they go to this go-to pass down the sideline. And again, it gets intercepted, and they think it's a free play, and it hasn't worked yet. And it has, I mean, the flag hasn't come out. Because I'm not sure he did cross into, well, it doesn't matter whether he did or not. The flag didn't come out for it.
Fifth interception offered up by the Eagles this season.
Darn it.
And that fires the Vandal crowd up, fires the Vandal sideline. And Terry, you mentioned to me before the kickoff, but Coach Petrino, this is certainly a benchmark game for him. And it's been a struggle in his three seasons here, trying to revive the program of Idaho. Really has had very little success since the 2009 season. And you take on in your opening conference game the conference champs on your turf, 2,100 miles away from home. This is a big game for the Vandals.
It's huge, and this is a big
turnover. After further
turnover.
Review, the rolling on the field is confirmed. First down, Idaho.
I agree with it. If you're watching back on the ESPN3, you can tune your, pause it, take your app and listen to us on the radio and get them synced up. Huge interception, but a great interception by the cornerback. He went up and pulled it down, was able to get that foot drag. And he maintained the ball on his way down, so it was a good call.
So now the Eagle defense trying to get something going here. They've held the Vandals in check so far. This is the third possession of the game for Matt Linehan and company. It'll be first out of 10. The ball at the Vandal 6-yard line. Linehan stands at the goal line. Penny on a wing to his right. Here's the shotgun snap. Comes out firing. Far side. Catch made up around the 11. Dropped immediately. Ruben Muela. But a good throw by Linehan just to get him some breathing room. Moves the ball up to the 11-yard line. Pick up a 5. It'll be second down and 5 for the Idaho Vandals.
Darius White on the play. Good job.
Second down, 4. Ball just shy of the 12-yard line. Linehan put it in the belly of Penny. Penny stood up, trying to get some help from his offensive lineman to move the pile. Not much doing there. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage.
No, he moved the pile. They're giving him a first down. The pile kept moving. And they didn't blow the whistle.
Wow.
Yeah.
So the Vandals get plenty of breathing room here after picking up the first down. Started at their own 6-yard line. Two receivers left, one to the short side of the field. That's the right. Shotgun snap, Linehan with time. Comes to the near side. Catch made at the 20-yard line. Ruben Wela again got loose momentarily and then is absolutely tattooed after trying to break free for a second time. It was Antoine Williams that said no more.
Surprised he was able to hold on to the ball after that hit. But a very good pickup for him. It puts him in a good second down situation again. Second and short.
So Muela with his second catch of the afternoon. 7-yard gain, makes it second down and 3. The ball at the 24-yard line. Time to give to Penny. He's hit at the line, and flag comes flying out. Antonio Glover that came in to close on the tackle.
Also Antoine Williams in there again. Maybe a holding call against, and it's going to be against Idaho. Holding call. See what,
second of the night for the Vandals.
Yep. Jay Ellison thought he was
holding.
Got a nice grip on him.
Offense number 61. 10 yards from the previous spot. Replay. Second down.
Very big penalty for the Eagles. Help us out quite a bit. Two turnovers on the day. They coughed one up. We get a field goal out of after we blocked the punt. The Eagles throw an interception. Idaho trying to put some points on the board as well. They got themselves some breathing room, as you mentioned, Chris, but a penalty is going to back them all the way up to the 13-yard line. Make it second down and forever.
Stephen Matlock, the guilty party, the junior out of nearby Boise, Idaho. 6.5 minutes to go. First quarter, still a 3-0 Georgia Southern lead. Now second down, 13. The ball at the Vandal 14-yard line. Here's the snap. They come after the quarterback. They'll drop it off of the screen, and they've got room. It's Hightower up the near side hash, eventually tripped up at the 28-yard line, but they'll pick up the first down.
Glover saved a touchdown there. Perfect call for them against a blitz. We were in there right on top of them.
So the Vandals start at the 6, have to backpedal after a penalty, and then a huge catch by Hightower, the junior out of Loganville, Georgia. Product of Grayson High School. Here's another throw, far side 35, and Desmond Epps, the team's leading receiver, hauls that catch in, moves up to the 36-yard line. Pickup of 8 yards. And now you can see the confidence of Matt Linehan. Again, as I mentioned, 70% of his passes are completed. Not hard throws so far, but the Eagles giving enough cushion. It's now been a matter of not giving them yards after the catch. They've been open for the most part. Second down and a short two. This time Linehan will keep, come around the right edge, lunge forward. He's got the first down at the 40-yard line.
Very intense ball game on this field right now. Idaho players are pretty jacked up.
Now the Vandals showing a ball possession offense here. Doing it with the pass. Moving the chains and moving down the field. It'll be first down and 10 at the Vandal 40-yard line. Linehan will set one back to the right side. That'll be Penny. Trip receivers to the left, the wide side of the field. Eagles with a four-man front. Slant. Catch made. It's Desmond Epps up at the 49-yard line. The Eagles again trying to use extra numbers to get to the quarterback. Credit Idaho, Terry. They're quick-hitting passes, not giving you time, and they're outnumbering the Eagles out in the flats. And on that slant, 9-yard gain, it'll be second down and one at the 49. Linehan, quick snap. Hand it off, running right side with it. Elijah Penny picks up the first down, gets the Eagle territory at the 46-yard line. Under 4.5 minutes to play here in the first quarter. Georgia Southern up 3-0. But Idaho coming to life here offensively, being orchestrated by the sophomore quarterback, Matt Linehan.
After a huge Georgia Southern turnover.
Linehan again has Penny on a wing to his left. He'll rise up, look to the near sideline. Send two receivers out to the left, one to the right side. Ball just inside the far side hash, under 4 minutes to go. 3 minutes and 49 seconds remaining, first quarter. Linehan again with time. Throws this one down the middle and overthrown. Had his man Desmond Epps. Broke separation just inside the near side hash, but that throw off the mark. Otherwise, that's an easy score for the Vandals walking in.
Yes, he got through the seam and just burned us. Tay Hicklin couldn't keep up with him. He was wide open, as you mentioned, overthrew him. Eagles been showing different three-man, four-man fronts, three linebackers, three-man front walking, two linebackers up, giving them different looks. This is the 10th play of the drive.
Second down and 10, again at the Eagle 45. Give to Penny, goes right off the right edge and just follows behind blockers down to the Eagle 40-yard line. Pickup of 6, it'll set up third down and 3. Here for the Vandals offense, we mentioned Desmond Epps had 15 catches in the opening game against Ohio. 10 receptions last week against the Wofford Terriers. And now we've got a timeout.
We had a substitution problem on the sideline, and probably not a bad time anyway to call a timeout, as it was about to be the 11th play of the drive, 3rd and 4.
So the Eagles burn the timeout with 3:18 remaining first quarter. Idaho building up a heap of steam here, marching down the field. They trail 3-0 to Georgia Southern. They'll look at 3rd down and 3 at the Eagle 39-yard line when we return to Moscow, Idaho in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
Georgia Southern leading Idaho 3-0, 3:18 to play in the first quarter. Time now to take a look around the Sun Belt scoreboard. It's brought to you by Spring Hill Suites. As the official hotel partner for Georgia Southern Athletics, they take care of the Eagles. They want to take care of you, too. Looking at that Sun Belt scoreboard, Toledo leading Arkansas State 30-7 in the third quarter. Akron all over Louisiana Lafayette 28-7. 3 minutes to go in the third there. All NC State in Mobile as they lead South Alabama 42-10. And Houston all over Texas State 41-7 as they play with right before the half. Chris.
Thank you, Russ. Idaho Vandals looking at the 11th play of this drive that started at their own 6-yard line. They now look at third down and 3 from the Eagle 39-yard line. The Eagles a much-needed timeout. Had defensive personnel issues, but maybe just the time they needed to catch their breath. Idaho comes out again firing. This time catch was made but incomplete, but a flag comes out at the 35-yard line. Deion Watson, 6'4", 220-pound junior out of Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, went up to get it, but he was completely molested. Let's see. Maybe they'll say it was going against Idaho. There was a lot of pushing and shoving over there at the 35. He could not hold on. Let's see what the call's all about.
Holding. Defense, number 19, 10 yards from the previous spot, automatic, first down.
Big penalty against Georgia Southern. Big turnover, Georgia Southern gave Idaho the ball at their own 6. Now the 11th, 12th play of this drive, and a huge penalty is going to put them inside the 30 at the 29 on a crucial third down. Now it's first and 10. This is where that tight end comes into play for Idaho.
Coach Willie Fritz not happy at all on that far sideline. First down and 10 now at the 29-yard line of Georgia Southern. Linehan with a shotgun snap. Late pressure, but unloads. This one's going to be caught down around the 5-yard line. It's Desmond Epps. That time they had coverage where they wanted it for Georgia Southern, but lost the football at the last moment. Darius Jones turned and looked too quickly. And when he did, Epps went up to the air, brought it down at the 5. And now, knocking on the door, first down, goal to go at the Georgia Southern 5-yard line. And now we've got a timeout.
I thought we were going to get an INT. It looked like Darius was in perfect position to make a play on that. Turned around to go after the ball and then turned back to the receiver and lost it.
So Idaho will call the timeout, their first here in the first half. Both teams have 2 remaining, 2:53 remaining in the first quarter. And Danny, I mentioned a few moments ago after that holding penalty, Coach Willie Fritz not happy. I think that's probably just adding insult to injury. I don't think he's happy about this drive altogether that was started by a Georgia Southern turnover.
Well, not only that, but I saw Alex Atkins in the offensive huddle seething at his offensive line. There's been a lot of backside pressure against Ellison because Georgia Southern's had to throw the ball a little bit more with Idaho stacking the box. The Eagles are going to have to throw. Eventually, that running game is going to open up, but the passing game is going to have to set up the run for at least the foreseeable future.
Well, Idaho will come out of the huddle near side. They'll line it up near side hash. First down, goal to go from the Georgia Southern 5-yard line. Eagles lead 3-0. Idaho wanting to take the lead here as Linehan looks back to the near side. Has 2 receiver out wide to the right. They'll move Penny on the wing to the left side. They'll motion the tight end across the formation left to right. They'll give to Penny. He'll try to hurdle his way down near the 2 as Chris De La Rosa wraps him up there. Second down, goal to go from the Georgia Southern 2 upcoming.
Good play call, and again, eating a lot of clock here early in this ballgame. 2:30 to go in the first quarter.
That time, the Vandals overload the right side, come back to the left with Penny. Now he'll line up. They'll go under center for Linehan with an I formation, a blocking fullback. Give to Penny, right side. Caught from behind and dropped. At the line of scrimmage, Antonio Glover sneaks in to make the tackle.
He came in hard off the corner, able to get him by the foot. Ironhead able to take him down. Third down, I think they may have lost a yard on that play.
Third down, goal to go. They mark it at the 2-yard line. Substitutions come in. Try to beefing up that front line here. Go with double tight side formation. Again from the near side hash. On third down, goal to go from the 2. Motion. Now Linehan with the snap. Give to Penny again. Hit behind the line. Antonio Glover got to him again. Stopped him shy of the goal line. Penny got a little more penetration that time, but not enough to break the plane.
Wow.
Dropped inside the one. It'll be fourth down goal to go from the one-yard line, and it looks like Austin Rico will come out and try to tie it up.
Wow.
And I think even the Vandal fans are a little surprised.
I am, too. You got to go 16 plays down on your own six. I know you want to walk away with some points here from your own six.
So Rico, who's about as automatic as it gets.
He was punting, too, and we blocked that one.
5 of 5 for field goals on the season. Placement down. Kick is up. Puts it in the net between the uprights, and we're tied 3-all. So after the Vandals march down the field with a drive starting at their own 6-yard line on an offered-up Georgia Southern interception, the defense holds inside the 5, and they have to go for the field goal to tie the game up 3-all. 1:03 remaining first quarter. We're tied here in Moscow. We'll return in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Kickoff. Idaho kicks it down to the 1-yard line. Derek Keaton returns it. The cut down at the 16. And the Eagles take over first down and 10 at their own 16-yard line with a tie game 3-3. And a turnover by the Eagles in their last possession on an interception offered up by Kevin Ellison. And the Vandals go down the field. And I guess, Terry, small victory for the Eagles. They're able to hold them inside their own 5-yard line for a field goal.
And I agree, as Upshaw checks in at quarterback. Great kickoff by Idaho. Good hang time, good coverage.
Third series of the night. Give to Breida. Breida looking for a hold. He's got it. Near side hash 40. 45 across midfield. He will not be caught. 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Matt Breida, 83 yards. That's his 9th in his career of over 60 yards. That's his 5th over 70. And once he got to about his own 20, shut out the lights. The Vandals nowhere close.
And this place got really quiet. 83 yards.
Wow.
Did I mention it's quiet? We can actually hear each other. I can hear Danny. He's not even using the microphone.
Alex Hankton for the point after. Placement down. Kick is up. Kick is good. And that, with one play, the Eagles answer. First touchdown of the night makes it 10-3 with 47 seconds remaining here in the first quarter of action. And Matt Breida, a couple of times he was hemmed in on the outside. That time just knifed it right between the tackles. And no time at all. He was able to go right down the field for 83 yards and kind of answer back that Vandal score.
It's not like there was a lot of room, Danny, in the middle there. It was just enough for him to squeeze through. And then again, once he got past the linebackers, it wasn't nobody going to catch him.
Terry, you remember the play last week against the Citadel. Got the block from Bird, and then he was off to the races again. This time it's 83, and according to you, that's still more than two 40-yard dashes, right?
It is, and as soon as I can see how long it took. Oh, my goodness, it took 11 seconds. Play drive again. So.
Fans Bullock Telephone, your local provider for voice, video, and data services. Serving all customers with fiber optic facilities and over 2,500 miles of fiber cable. Bullock Telephone, the home for the latest telecommunication technology. Bullock Telephone, serving Bullock County since 1951. Penny and Duckworth will be back deep for the Vandals. Alex Hanks to tee it up at the 35-yard line, kicking this one left to right inside the dome. Here's the approach. High, not very deep. He fielded by Duckworth at the goal line. Hit at the knees as he crossed the 10. Not much more after that. Maybe just shy of the 13-yard line.
They did it. We did it. Good job. The high hang time kickoffs that land around the 1-yard line. You got to bring it out. Gives your team get down there to make the tackle. Good job for the Eagles on that one. Great coverage.
Fans, don't forget the dream team at Colonial House of Flowers, handpicked to share their unique talents. They're dedicated, loyal, and incredibly creative. Colonial House of Flowers, official florist to Georgia Southern Athletics.
If there is a bad part about an 83-yard touchdown using 11 seconds, it didn't give your defense a lot of time to breathe and get a rest.
Matt Lenahan back on the field with the Vandal offense. Two receivers right, one to the left, single back. Comes out firing, looking for his back, and it's going to be Duckworth. He's got room up across the 20. Bounced out of bounds just shy of the 25-yard line, far side. Coming into the game, not only is Lenahan very effective at 70% completion, but also distributing the ball to 12, 13 different receivers, including his running backs.
He's a good-looking quarterback out there.
First down and 10. Give right up the middle. Duckworth crosses over the 25, just shy of the 27-yard line. A pickup of maybe two. It'll be second down and 8 here for the Vandal offense. Maybe the final play of the first quarter. There's 10 seconds remaining.
Eagles, as I mentioned earlier, has been showing a 3 and a 4-man front, walking the linebackers up to blitz, and they're not going to get this play off as we're moving into the second quarter.
So the first quarter comes to an end. They'll switch sides of the field. After one stanza, Georgia Southern leading 10-3 over the Idaho Vandals. Vandals have the football, looking at 2nd and 8 at their own 27-yard line when we return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Start of the second quarter here in Moscow, Idaho. 10-3, Georgia Southern leading over the Idaho Vandals. Taking a look at the Baden-Nissan stat line presented by Baden-Nissan of Statesboro. Serving Savannah, Vidalia, Hinesville, and all of Eagle Nation. Baden-Nissan of Statesboro, proud supporter of Georgia Southern Athletics. Through one period of play, Georgia Southern 123 yards of total offense, 83 of that coming off the legs of Matt Breda on a touchdown score. Idaho Vandals 115 yards of total offense. Eagles have thrown for 35 yards, the Vandals 82 yards. Matt Lenahan, 7 of 10, right at his 70% average. Thrown for those 82 yards. Kevin Ellison, 2 of 5 passing for 35 yards. Does have the interception that resulted in the field goal for the Vandals. Matt Breda, as I mentioned, 83-yard carry for a touchdown. He's got 3 for 84 yards. Kevin Ellison has scampered on 2 occasions for just 3 yards, and L.A. Ramsby, 1 carry for 1 yard. So the Vandals come out, moving the other way, left to right on your dial, looking at 2nd down and 8 at their own 27-yard line.
You think the dance cam ever shoots up here to our booth? We probably want to be careful.
You keep dancing the way doing, and it probably will.
That'd be a YouTube sensation.
Waiting for the internet timeout to finish up. Not a huge crowd on hand, but I know, Terry, you and Danny were talking about the countdown to kickoff. Just simple nature of being inside, this crowd still can be loud, and they were fired up after the Vandals picked off the pass from Kevin Ellison. But it got extremely quiet. When it's loud, it's loud, and when it's quiet, it's very quiet after that 83-yard touchdown run. 2nd down and 8. Vandals ready to roll. Lenahan in the shotgun, waiting on the snap. Here it comes. Play action. Looking downfield. Pressure coming. He unloads, and incomplete up around midfield. A late flag coming out. They were looking for Desmond Epps. Darius Jones trying to stay with him. He faced up the receiver, but they're going to say a little too much contact.
Well, from the judge on the very far back side through the flag. Now, he didn't turn around to face it, but he doesn't have to, I don't believe. There must have been some contact there. But he threw it from all the way across the field. But on that note, I want to tell you, Matt Lenahan took a shot.
Pass interference. Defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
That's debatable. But anyway, he took another hard shot as he released the ball and dived. Whatever. Anyway, he was right there. He just needs to turn around and make that play. Darius Jones does.
Second penalty for 25 yards here in the game. And Coach Willie Fritz and his plan to win. Talks about Eagles don't beat Eagles and winning the turnover battle. And so far, not going the Eagles' way. First down and 10, now at the 42-yard line. Give on the carry to Elijah Penny. Again, churns his way up to about the 46-yard line after being hit at the line. Good pickup of 5 yards. Should set up second down and 5 as he just went right up the gut.
Hard runner.
Big back at 6'2", 234 pounds. Again, the senior out of Lakewood, California.
Second penalty on the day for the Eagles.
Ball at the 46-yard line. Another play action. Linehan looking near side. One-on-one coverage and broken up down around the 15-yard line by Caleb Williams. Timed out perfectly. They were looking for Hightower.
They got a flag in the middle here. Hopefully that'll be a holding against them and pushing back. But right in the gap, Caleb Williams stayed with him. The difference this time is Caleb turned back and played the ball. Again, a little bit of pushing and shoving in that one as well. And I was almost expecting the flag to come out there because he had some hands, but I think it was an illegal man downfield. Offensive lineman got too happy, I believe.
Ineligible man downfield. Offense, number 67. That penalty is declined. Third down.
Mason Woods going out to field a pass. 336-pounder.
And again, running with him, and a lot of contact from the corner and the receivers so far in this game.
Third down, 6. Again, the ball at the 46-yard line. Trip receivers left. Linehan in the gun. Penny back there to block. Now he'll release. Linehan with all day now will run to his right. Backpedaling in trouble. Hit as he throws. Incomplete at the 45-yard line. Deshante Ironhead Gallon delivered the blow to Linehan as he released the football. They were looking for Jonte Boston, Caleb Williams on coverage, and Linehan slow to get up, and he will wobbly make his way to the near sideline.
He's been slow to get up several times. Back earlier on the goal line stand for the Eagles, he was a little gimpy then as well. He's taken two hard shots here. The crowd wanted a pass interference there. I think he might have been either right of the line of scrimmage trying to make the catch or not. He certainly got hit a little early, but the flag did not come out.
Rico in to punt it away. Try to make field position here. He'll boot it away from the 35. High kick, angling near side. Takes a high bounce at the 20, and then an eagle bounce at the 19, and it'll be down at the 19-yard line.
Not a great punt. Very surprised by that one.
13:56 remaining. First half action. Eagles lead 10-3 over Idaho. Timeout on the field. We'll return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Range here in the first half. Georgia Southern leading Idaho in the Sun Belt Conference opener 10-3 here in Moscow, Idaho. Let's go down on the field, check in on the Optum Orthopedic Eagle injury update. Optum Orthopedics and physician owned Optum Medical Center in Tatnall. Optum Healthcare, the official orthopedic care provider to the Georgia Southern Eagles. Danny, it's good to see B.J. Johnson able to shake off having the wind knocked out of him, but Logan Hunt, they're taking a little more look at him after he was banged up early in the first quarter.
Yeah, it's taking a little bit longer with Hunt. He had some ice on for about 15 minutes. He was riding the bike real quickly. The ice is off. He just gave me a thumbs up. I don't know when he's coming back, but it's looking likely that he is going to return at some point. Just don't know when.
13:56. Eagles making life difficult for Matt Linehan. Came off a little slow. They're coming up short on the incompletion on third down. Eagles will line up first down and 10 from their own 19-yard line. Give to Ramsby, and Ramsby, a little bit of a crease. Battles his way up to the 28-yard line. Fabian Upshaw staying in at quarterback after really not being able to work a whole lot of that third drive. One play handed off to Matt Breeden, 83 yards later, take a break. So Upshaw stays in at quarterback. 9-yard gain by Ramsby, sets up second down and 1. Just shy of the 28-yard line. Ramsby will stay in as the back. James Dean in as the H-back. Two receivers right, one to the left. Upshaw calling for the pistol snap. Helmet high, gives it off to Ramsby. He'll pick up the Franklin first down. Ramble his way to the 31-yard line. Caden Ellis, outside linebacker, making the stop. It'll be a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Each time the Eagles pick up a first down, it's presented by Franklin Toyota. On the bypass in Statesboro or online anytime at franklintoyota.com. Matt Breida checks in after Ramsby picks up the first down. He'll be in the backfield along with Upshaw on first down and 10 from the 31. Rollout for Upshaw, fires this one, looking, and catch is hauled in at the Vandal 47-yard line by B.J. Johnson. Johnson with his third catch, that time outran the coverage. And Upshaw throwing to the boundary, and Johnson again having to make a low catch, but hauls it in. He'll check out momentarily as they pick up the Franklin first down. First and 10 now at the Vandal 47-yard line.
That definitely was not a slow rollout, was it? He was a sprint fire.
One receiver far to the right side. Two to the left side. Here's the snap. Option pitch on the speed option. Gives it to Breida. Near side. Looking for blockers. 45. Bounces it near the boundary. And out of bounds at the 34-yard line of Idaho. Another Franklin first down off the legs of Matt Breida. Miles Campbell doing a good job out on the corner. Gave Breida the block he needed to pick up another 6 yards.
Fifth
now
play.
The offense. Terry, sorry. Offense now starting to roll.
Yeah, fifth play of this drive. Started on our own 19-yard line.
First down and 10. Ball at the 34-yard line. Near side hash. Snap to Upshaw. Give to Breida. Try the A-gap right side, flipped up end over end, and he is coming up very painful as he comes and rolls on his back at the 30-yard line. Armin Hawkins laid the hit. I'm not sure if it was the hit that was low or when he hit the turf, but he grimaced immediately after hitting on the ground.
Maybe his shoulder. Again, it could be either way, but you saw it. It hurt me up here when he came down with the ball, and he immediately...
His feet were taken out from under him, and his upper body landed on the turf here inside the Kiwi Dome. Training crew out to take a look here. The clock stopped 11 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. And you can tell by his body language in an enormous amount of pain.
Eagle Nation holding their breath right now everywhere.
Came down awkward.
That right shoulder?
Yeah, on his right shoulder. Now he hops up. For the most part, on his own power.
We can breathe, Eagle Nation. Breathe.
Now he will get to a slow trot to the far sideline. Still kind of gingerly holding that right shoulder as L.A. Ramsby will check in and replace Breida. Gain of 4 yards on that carry. It was a hard 4 yards for Matt. Sets up second down and 6. Ball placed at the 30-yard line just inside the near side hash. Johnson will motion at the snap, right to left. They'll counter option the far side. Upshaw pitch to Ramsby, far side 30, 25, 20. He'll leap into the air. Let's see where they mark him out. Down around the 17-yard line is Ramsby.
Wow.
Putting on the air show. It's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
You know, receivers, I don't think get enough credit for being great blockers as well. Miles Campbell out there again. No, Keegan Williams out there doing a great job of blocking.
First down and 10, inside the clubhouse red zone with the ball placed on the far hash mark at the 16-yard line of Idaho. High snap, give to Wesley Fields, the freshman, going A-gap, then cutting back to his left inside the 15, down around the 13-yard line before Jordan Grabsby, safety, sophomore, out of Bradenton, Florida. Majority of the team here for the Vandals coming out of course, locally here in the state of Idaho, state of California, state of Washington. Few from the state of Georgia, as the aforementioned Grabsky out of the Sunshine State. 3 yard gain by Field sets up second down 7. The ball at the 13-yard line of the Vandals. Four man front. Vandals say they're coming after it this time. Give to Fields, and he'll be hit after getting to the line of scrimmage. Not much doing there. He's bounced to the outside. Ed Hall made the tackle. That'll set up third down and 7 here with, again, the ball at the 13-yard line.
Yeah, nowhere to go.
Eagles have been inside the Idaho red zone on 2 occasions. First one in the opening drive after the block punt resulted in a field goal from Alex Hanks, and this is a critical third down here on the 9th play of the drive with 10 minutes remaining in the first half. Third and 7, ball at the 13-yard line of the Vandals. Motion Keaton far from the left to right. Upshaw wanting to throw, slings the ball, incomplete in the end zone. It'll set up fourth down and seven. They were looking for Keaton.
And Ramsby flares out wide open in the flats. Went right across the middle as Alex Hanks trots out on the field. Ball looks like it's probably going to be spotted around the, 20, 20 and a half yard line. 30-yard field goal for Hanks.
So Hanks with a chance to extend the lead. Matt Dobson will hold. Here comes the snap. Placement down. Kick is up. Plenty of leg. Hits the net and the uprights, or through the uprights, and good. 13-3. So Alex Hanks with his second field goal of the game.
Good job, Alex.
Makes it a 10-point lead with 9:45 remaining in the first half and a timeout on the field. We'll take one with him. We'll return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Five remains here in the first half. Georgia Southern extends the lead 13-3 off the foot of Alex Hanks. Fans, remember, Food World has the largest selection of organic and gluten-free items for your tailgate or anytime. Visit them on Fair Road or any of their five locations in the Southeast. Food World, the official grocer of Georgia Southern Athletics. Terry, again, a good drive overall for Georgia Southern. Scary moment when Matt Rita goes down. We'll get an update on him, but Upshaw, Ramsby, get down inside the red zone, unable to get it in for the touchdown. But Alex Hanks comes in, does his job, and extends the lead 13-3.
Yeah, it's a 10-play drive, ate up 4 minutes and 11 seconds on the clock, which is crucial to give our defense some more time to get their legs underneath them. 67 yards, 10 plays, start on their own 19-yard line. Not able to push it in for a touchdown, but Hanks comes through. Mr. Reliable so far this year extends it 13-3 as Youngway Koo kicks off for the Eagles.
Youngway puts this one midway through the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles will let the Vandals get started at their own 25-yard line with 9:45 remaining here in the second quarter. Let's quickly go down on the field again. Danny Reed on the Optum Orthopedic Eagle injury update. Any indication as to the extent of Matt Rita's injury on that last drive?
He was getting examined by trainer Brandy Klaus. The mobility in the right shoulder looks fine. He rejoined the offensive huddle. He had a pep in the step. Matt Reed is just fine.
Good news, 9:45 remains as the Vandals come out. Linehan trying to shake off a hard hit last time they were on the field as the Eagles again have been a step or two away from adding more than just one sack in this game. Here's a quick rollout pass to Penny, caught at the 25, rambled out of bounds just shy of the 30-yard line. Chris Della Rosa running the lines and making the tackle for the Eagles.
Good pitch and catch. Wondered how Linehan was going to handle coming back after getting hit. He's still showing some favoritism to that gimpy leg.
Second down, 5. Just shy of the 30-yard line. Linehan on the give. It'll be Duckworth spreading the field near side. Now finds an alley up across the 35. Spilled out end over end, but up at the 40-yard line for the first down to the Idaho Vandals.
Very hard run. Hate to see Hicks lower his head like that. That scary Higlin did that on that particular play.
First down and 10. Ball at the 40-yard line. Vandals down 13-3. Al Linehan looking to the near side.
Four-man front for the Eagles, back to the traditional. Well, they got two linebackers in.
With 9 minutes, Linehan takes the snap. Time in the pocket. Ooh. Goes up the middle and strike caught. It's going to be Desmond Epps. Gets behind everybody and he'll go in for the score. Make it 13-9. A 60-yard pass from Linehan to Desmond Epps. Epps, his first touchdown of the season.
He just burned him. Made one quick move, was down the sideline, about 10 yards in from the sideline, just outrunning. Perfectly delivered pass by Linehan. So not being able to punch it in and settling for field goals certainly may come back to haunt us.
It's a high snap, but placed down, and Rico puts it up and in. So quickly, it's a 13-10 Georgia Southern lead with 8:52 remaining here in the first half. Lenahan continues to spread the ball around the field and do it effectively. He's now 8 of 13.
They certainly like the matchup there. They picked on him several times out that way. You get that two linebacker set, four-man front.
So the Eagles have a chance here. Still plenty of time in the second quarter to get back on track. Offensively, maybe answer that score.
Place livens up quite a bit. Again, what they've done so far, they've had a few touchbacks. But the kickoffs, really the strategy here, unless they're just going to boom it out of the end zone, is get that great hang time on it so your guys can get down there. You try to stop them inside the 15 or the 20 versus getting a touchback and they start on the 25. 8:52 to go until half.
Rico to kick it off there. Keaton back deep for the Eagles, stands at the goal line. Lenahan with that touchdown pass, now 9 of 14, 147 yards. Here's the approach by Rico. Puts a foot in this one. High, spinning, end over end. 2 yards deep. Keaton will bring it out. Far side, up the hash. And trip down, cut down as he made it to the 15-yard line.
Looked like
there would be a crease there, and he's looking to get through it. But tripped up right around the 12-yard line, and the Eagles will start first down and 10.
They're going to spot the ball, looks like, at the 20 for us. Again, it's just a tough decision, 2 and 3 yards deep, when you get that kind of hang time up there. A low-line drive kick, I can understand it.
So Matt Breida will check in to the Georgia Southern offense. Back at quarterback is Kevin Ellison. First down and 10, they mark it at the Eagle 20-yard line after the return. Set up the option coming near side. Ellison pitch to Breida. 20, 25, 30, building up ahead of steam. Runs out of room, knocked into the boundary at the 36-yard line, but a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
Big pickup.
Nice separation that time. Ellison and Breida, great spacing, allowing the pitch to come. Idaho not in position, and Breida ripping off the yardage for the first down.
16-yard gallop around the end.
Eagles break from the huddle. 8.5 minutes to go, second quarter, leading 13-10. Two receivers right, one to the left. Put it in the belly of Breida. Come around the near side, trying to outrun some Vandals. Brought down after making it to about the 37. So not much doing there. Jordan Grabsby again. Safety finding Breida first. Got his arms around him to bring him down. Set up. Second down. And a little less than 9. They'll say second and 8 as Elliott Ramsby back into the offensive backfield. We've seen Ramsby, Breida, and Wesley Fields. Two receivers sent out wide to the right. Ramsby on the right side of Ellison. Sprint out for Kevin. Throws and whistle blows, and play is halted. Flag down at the 37-yard line, far side.
Well, they brought the house on that particular play, and maybe it offsides against Idaho, I hope.
Full start. Offense. Ooh. On the 31.
Okay.
5-yard penalty. Still second down.
We got a little jumpy on there, but they had their 4-3 defense, and they walk up a safety, and then a corner actually looked like he wanted to come as well. So we jumped off to be our, what, fourth penalty on the day. Check that. Third penalty. Southern now is, instead of second and 8, second 9, now we're looking at second 14.
So on the third penalty of the day for the Eagles, they'll look at second and 14 back at the 32-yard line. Give to Ramsby, cross buck the right side, up the A-gap across the 35, gets near the 38-yard line. Pickup of 6, Chris Edwards on the tackle for the Idaho Vandals. It sets up third down and 8 upcoming. Eagles just 1 of 3 on third down so far tonight. And with a 13-10 Georgia Southern lead and 7.5 minutes to go in the first half, a crucial third down opportunity. Ellison will line up as Wesley Fields, the freshman from Americus, will be the featured back. Two receivers right, wide side of the field. Two to the left, the short side. They show a corner blitz. Here comes the snap. They're coming after Ellison. Here's the draw. Ellison with room right up the middle. Across midfield. High steps his way inside the 45. Lunges his way to the Vandal 40-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
Wow.
What a call by Doug Roos and the offensive staff. Idaho showing no doubt they were coming after Ellison. They came on the corners. And Ellison right up the middle.
Beautiful, beautiful play call and execution. Pause just enough.
Ready to get back to work. First down and 10. Now at the Vandal 40-yard line. After the 19-yard run by Kevin Ellison. Sends two receivers to the right, one to the left side. Vandals with a four-man front. Linebackers cheating up. Now the corner coming in on the action. Here's the snap on first down and 10. Ellison wants to throw. Swings it out far side. Fields catches it 25. Or rather 35. And then spins out of bounds. Almost ran out of room over there around the 25-yard line. Brock Westlake forces him out, makes his way down to the 21-yard line of the Vandals.
What great athleticism Wesley Fields show. Jumping up to catch the ball, jumps over a defender, stays on his feet, picks up another 4 to 6 yards. That was beautiful.
So Fields getting it done on the swing pass, first down and 10, just outside the clubhouse red zone at the Idaho 21-yard line. Far side hash. Ellison takes the snap, fires near side. This one behind the intended receiver at the 15. He was looking for Derek Keaton. Keaton coming to the near sideline, ball thrown behind him towards the hash marks. That'll set up second down and 10 at the 21.
Hopefully this passing also will loosen up inside. May see Breida break another one here.
Second down, 10, 21-yard line of the Idaho Vandals. Eagles lead by 3, 13-10 over the homestanding Idaho squad. With 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Ellison calling for the snap. Here it comes. Ellison to keep it. And Ellison caught down around the ankles. Falls forward to the 18-yard line. Pickup of 3. Caden Ellis able to hold on to the ankles and not let Ellison get free. And with 5:48 to go, it'll be a critical third down here.
Very good play by Ellison there. They took out the pitch man right away. He was able to cut it and get some positive yards.
Third down and 7 at the 18-yard line inside the clubhouse red zone. The Eagles, as far as touchdowns concerned, 0-for-2 in the red zone so far today. They've got 2 field goals. Trying to get in the end zone here in a tight game, leading 13-10. Breida in the backfield, play action. Here comes the pressure. Ellison jump pass, but it's going to be short to B.J. Johnson. B.J. standing on the goal line. Pass hops off the turf at about the 3. That'll set up 4th down and 7. And again, Alex Hanks on to try to add 3 more.
9th play of this drive, stalling on a field goal. Hanks going to have it spotted at the 25, 35-yard field goal for Hanks. Again, they brought the house. A lot of pressure on Ellison. Wasn't able to look for open receivers.
So a 35-yarder right down Broadway. Snap, placement down, kick is up. Again, plenty of leg, and this one is good. So Alex Hanks with his 3rd field goal of the night extends the lead 16-10 over the Idaho Vandals with 5:13 to go here in the first half. We'll take a timeout, return to the Kimmy Dome in just a moment. Our score, Georgia Southern 16, Idaho 10. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, there's no doubt you love the Eagles, so consider buying or renewing an Eagle Wildlife Plate. Just $25 more helps provide vital support for conserving rare wildlife across the state of Georgia. For more details, go to GeorgiaWildlife.com. 5:13 remains here in the second quarter. Eagles in a tight one here on the road. Moscow, Idaho, 16-10. They lead. Alex Hanks, 9 points so far in the ballgame. 3 field goals. Young Waiku again will tee it up at the 35-yard line. Kick it back to the Idaho Vandals. Again, the Eagles, Terry, able to move down the field. But unfortunately, stall inside the red zone. Alex Hanks having to come on and do it one more time.
As you mentioned, we've been, 100% in the red zone. They've just been field goals, unfortunately. But we'll take the points as we lead 16-10. 9-play drive for the Eagles. 8 up, 3:34 of the clock. 62 yards as Young Wei Koo
kicks off about 8-9 yards deep in the end zone. Your Domino's Pizza Drive delivery brought to you by Domino's. Domino's is up really late. Folks on the East Coast, back in Eagle Nation, I know you're up really late listening to us. So go to Domino's.com and have a Domino's Pizza delivered to your home.
5:13 remaining. Idaho will come back out on offense. Coach Petrino and company got to be pleased with most of the effort here tonight. Matt Linehan showing what a difference a year makes. So far, 9 of 14, 147 yards and a touchdown. That one to Desmond Epps, who has four catches for 102 yards. Already has thrown to four different targets in the game. First down and 10 at the 25-yard line. Linehan gets the snap. Puts it in the belly of Elijah Penny, and Penny works his way to the 30-yard line, pickup of five. Clock begins to move, 5:05 remaining here in the second quarter. Checking the Vaden-Nissan stat line, Georgia Southern, 258 yards of total offense for Idaho, 199 after that last play. Again, the majority of it being done through the air, 147 passing yards for Idaho, and 76 through the air for Georgia Southern. As they try to work on their passing game here in week number four. Second down and five. Throw the near side in the flat. Covered up nicely and nowhere close. They were looking for Hightower. Missed throw by Linehan. Darius White was right there in the vicinity. Sets up third down and five. The ball at the 30-yard line. And that time, one of the few times Linehan has really thrown into coverage. No open man over on the near side flat.
He didn't have a choice. We had a linebacker blitzing on that. We were all in his face. Ill-advised throw. We almost pulled off a big one there.
Third and five at the 30-yard line. Linehan sends out trip receivers left, one to the near side. Here's the snap. Looking left with time, pumps the football, now fires. Drag route caught at the 35. Elijah Penny across midfield. Finally hemmed up and stopped at the Eagle 46-yard line. Big throw, big third down conversion. And the Vandals will move the chains and keep on trucking.
Their first third down conversion of the day comes with a great time for them as they're trying to take the lead on Georgia Southern going into halftime. Just not able to stay with him or wrap up, Chris.
So Penny sneaks out of the backfield, hauls in the catch, big play as Linehan takes the snap. Quick fire on the slant. Catch is made by Epps inside the 40, down to the Eagle 36-yard line. Fifth catch of the night.
Very close.
Senior out of Sacramento.
Very close to a first down there to try and decide if they want to measure, and they're not going to. So second, probably a nose of the ball.
So second and short here, under 4 minutes to play. Idaho on the attack. Now Linehan rises up out of the gun. He's got Penny on the hip to the right side. Takes the snap, design run, coming right back to his left. Brought down at the 34, but enough room for Linehan as Lenny Richardson tried to get to him behind the line of scrimmage. But the sophomore quarterback will move the chains and refresh the downs for the Vandals with 3:32 remaining.
Richardson tried to yank that ball out of his arms. Linehan able to hold on to it. We're back to a traditional four-man front now. As big old Darius Saps checks back into the ballgame.
Logan Hunt, the defensive end who was injured early in the first quarter, has now been taken back to the locker room. Again, looking at an ankle injury. First down and 10 at the 35. Stretch play coming near side. Penny just moves the pile down inside the 30, just shy of the 28-yard line. And the offensive line firing off the football here for the Idaho Vandals. They've done it on three occasions, but they have really up their game on this drive here, making haste with under 3 minutes to go in the first half. Quick snap, give to Penny, tries the A-gap right side, inside the 25, stops shy of the 24-yard line.
Moving the ball here, eating a lot of clock, but trying to score and not give it back to Southern. By the way, in a defensive end throughout the game, in and out, has been Ryan George.
He got 4.5 yards on the carry. It's good enough for a first down. So now first and 10 at the Eagle 25-yard line. Vandals on the attack. Linehan with Penny on a wing to his left, looking to throw. Near side, one-on-one. The Eagles find it and break it up in the right corner of the end zone. Darius White on Hightower, and Linehan took another shot. Matt Dobson got him. And Linehan again slow to get up, but that's nothing new. He's been hobbling along since the second possession of the game for the Vandals. So a timeout on the field, and also slow to get up, Darius White, who was on coverage. He is down, sitting up in the right corner of the end zone. So play is halted here with 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Timeout taken on the field. 16-10, Georgia Southern with the lead, but Idaho not backing down. An important final 2 minutes and 20 seconds here to set the tone going into the halftime locker room.
A lot of confidence on this Idaho sideline and from these players. Ninth play of the drive coming up, is starting on their own 25-yard line with 5:13 to go until half. They've been able to march down the field, leaving 2 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock. They're within field goal range, but they want a touchdown as Linehan limps back out quarterback position.
Caleb Williams will be your corner to the right side. Riyadh Jones, the corner, to the left side as Linehan looks at second down and 10 at the 25-yard line. Give to Duckworth, trying to stretch but then cutting it inside, making his way to the 23-yard line before Antoine Williams stops the play. Clock moving, 2 minutes, 7 seconds. Coming up, the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. And before that, Danny Reed will talk to a very concerned Coach Willie Fritz here. Headed into the locker room. 1 of 5 on third down so far tonight. But an important one here for the Vandals. 3rd and 8 at the 23-yard line of the Eagles. Linehan will send a receiver far to the left side. 2 receivers to the near side. Desmond Epps in the slot to the right. Penny, the single back, there to block. Looking for Epps and in his hands, but incomplete. Down around the 14-yard line.
I think he could probably feel the breath of Antoine Williams about ready to take him out or dislodge it. Not able to hold on to it for Epps, who has got great hands. As Idaho now has to try to settle for a field goal, the ball's going to be spotted to 30. It's a 40-yarder well within his range. Hoping to pull Idaho within 3 is what they're trying to do.
Rico already a 40-yarder to his credit this season. Hash mark near side. Kicking left to right. Placement is down. Gets a foot in this one. Hits up high on the back wall and good. Cuts the lead 16-13 with a minute 27 to go in the first half. So the Vandals getting points where they can get them here at home. Tighten up the game. It's a 3-point Georgia Southern lead.
Well, we got a 1:27. We got enough time. Thankfully, as we've learned in the past, we've only needed 11 seconds. And I don't think Idaho doesn't know that as well. Sure, they would have liked to held the ball a little bit longer, Danny.
In that instance, Desmond Epps should have had that ball. Granted, if Antoine Williams was coming at me, I probably would have dropped it too.
One thing, Danny, that concerns me is Idaho's done a very good job defensively of switching up what they do up front and when they bring pressure. The Eagles have been able to subside that a little bit on some quarterback draws. But for the most part, I got to believe this Eagle offensive front having trouble containing the Idaho Vandal defense.
Well, the key to the Vandals' pressure so far has been the safety blitz. And for the most time, it's coming away from the twins. When Georgia Southern has been out of the pistol, most of the time they're going twins to the far side of the field. That blitz is coming from the weak side, expecting that handoff to go towards the weak. That's why the quarterback draw was open, because the middle of the field was gaping.
Derek Keaton back deep for the Eagles. Rico tees it up at the 35-yard line, almost straight up on that tee. Very little angle on that football as Rico with the kick puts this one end over end, spinning football and out of the back of the end zone. It'll be a touchback, and the Eagles start first down and 10 at the 25-yard line. A minute 27 to go here in the first half, 16-13. Georgia Southern leads by 3. Eagles will have the football here and would love to get something going. Eke out the rest of the second quarter clock and put points on the board, preferably a touchdown. Fans, remember to stay connected with your favorite team anytime from anywhere. Just log on to gseagles.com, official athletic website of the Georgia Southern Eagles. First down and 10 at the 25. Kevin Ellison, Matt Breida in the offensive backfield. They'll send out receivers and B.J. Johnson, Derek Keaton to the left side. Now they'll motion Keaton at the snap. He'll be in the offensive backfield to give to Breida. Stutter step, couldn't find the hole, and brought down behind the line. May have lost a yard. Very rarely does Matt Breida lose yardage, but Brock Westlake got a hat on him first, and with 1:15 to go here in the first half, Eagles looking at second down and 11.
Did a good job of pushing back or attack on that play. Linebacker able to squeeze through.
Johnson and Keaton wide to the left side. This time Longoria lines up as the wide receiver to the right. L.A. Ramsby in as the featured back with Kevin Ellison. Snap back, speed option. Ellison pitch to Ramsby near side. 25-30, cuts back middle of the field, across the 40 before being spilled there at the 42-yard line. Armin Hawkins on the tackle, the safety making the play, and 42 seconds clock moving. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles off the legs of L.A. Ramsby. The clock continued to move, and now with 30 seconds, Ellison takes the snap on first down and 10 from the Eagle 42. Long throw far side of the field, catch made at midfield. About 3 yards after the catch for Longoria, 12-yard reception. Longoria hauls it in, Kendrick Trotter on the tackle, and with 23 seconds, they do stop the clock, and it begins to move again as they set the chains with 18 seconds. 15 seconds. Ellison waiting on the snap. Here it comes. Ellison pumps. Now hit as he throws, and this one thrown away and incomplete down at the 32-yard line.
Maybe the clock will stop now.
That was sarcasm, I know.
9 seconds left to go till half. Eagles not in field goal range at this point.
It'll be a tight window here with 9 seconds. Possibly go for an out route. You have to do it quickly to try to get Alex Hanks in field goal position. But the timeout is going to be taken by the Idaho Vandals here with 9 seconds. They'll talk it over. Their second of the half remains one in their pocket. So the Eagles will try to regroup and give the coaching staff time to decide here. But Terry, as I mentioned, 9 seconds on the clock. We know less than 9 seconds, to be honest. Ball placed at the 47-yard line of Idaho. Playing on that far side hash, the Eagles bench, if you will, may have time to chuck it down the field, get out of bounds, and try to get Alex Hanks on for a field goal here to try to answer that score. Now leading just 16-13 over Idaho in the waning moments of the second quarter.
Yeah, you have two timeouts in your pocket right now. Obviously, traditional thinking is throw it towards the sideline, get out of bounds. Even if you have to go across the middle, you're up and up with a quick timeout. But you got to talk about a quick release from L.A., I mean, from Ellison here.
So the crowd on their feet inside the Kibbe Dome with 9 seconds remaining in the first half. Second down and 10 at the Idaho 47-yard line. They look like they're coming off the corners, and they are. Ellison throws down the sideline and nowhere close. Looking for B.J. Johnson, but it's incomplete. Stops the clock with 6 seconds. It may be a heave-ho here.
That's also a situation where you're hoping you're going to get maybe a penalty or something along those lines, pass interference, and move the ball a little bit. Not able to do good pressure by Idaho. Place is getting loud here.
Vandals doing a good job on that second down play of squeezing the pocket with the corners off the edge.
Three-man front for Idaho here. Everybody back as they should be.
Third down and 10. Ball at the Idaho 47-yard line. More than likely, final play of the half. Ellison, rush from the pocket, now stepping up. Trohops lets this one fly towards the end zone in triple coverage, and it's knocked down. He was looking for Longoria. Ryan lobbying for a flag. It won't come. Dorian Clark batted the ball down, and the first half comes to an end. So Idaho with momentum. They don't lead on the scoreboard, but right now feeling good. Down 16-13 to Georgia Southern. Let's go down on the field. Danny Reed catching up with head coach Willie Fritz.
Coach, on offense so far, it looks like it's been the big play.
Yeah, you know, we've got to hit a couple big ones, and, you know, we got to score a touchdown instead of settling for field goals.
Defensively, you had the punt block. You had the goal line stand, but it looks like Idaho's starting to open up the passing game a little bit. How do you combat it in the second half?
Yeah, we just got to do a good job of staying over the top and not allowing the big one. You know, we just, you know, had a bust and got beat deep on the one deep play, but we'll be all right.
Thanks, Coach. Chris, back to you.
Thank you, Danny. Thank you, Coach. We're at halftime here at the Kibbe Dome, and a tight one on a Saturday night in Idaho. Georgia Southern leads 16-13 over the homestanding Idaho Vandals. Up next, it's the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Russ Brown will step in, take you through the first half stats, highlights, and of course scores from around the country. Jerry and I will rejoin you coming up to the start of the third quarter. Our score at the break, Georgia Southern 16, Idaho 13. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
This has been the Southern Halftime Report. The second half is just around the corner on the Georgia Southern Sports Network. Now, once again, with the call of the game, here's the voice of the Eagles, Chris Blair.
Back inside the Kibbe Dome here on this Saturday night. And he's set to start the second half of action here. Georgia Southern and Idaho in the Sun Belt Conference opener. Eagles leading 16-13 after two quarters of action. Checking the Vaden-Nissan stat line. Eagles with 286 yards of total offense on 34 plays. The Idaho Vandals, 246 yards total offense on 38 plays. Matt Linehan, 11 of 19, 180 passing yards and one touchdown. For the Eagles, the lone bright spot offensively, Matt Breida, 8 carries, 123 yards, but had a long of 83 for the only touchdown tonight for the Eagles. Alex Hanks has put in 9 points. Second half kickoff presented by Georgia Farm Bureau and your Georgia Farm Bureau agents. The coin was won by Idaho. They wanted the football, so they'll kick off, start the second half. Keaton takes it around the 5-yard line, far side. Had some running room and then runs out of room just across the 20. Stop there. Rico doing a pretty good job of forcing the return. The Eagles start at the 21-yard line of their very own, attacking right to left on your dial. And Terry, if you take a look at that first half, again, I just mentioned the stat line, but really it just seems like maybe this trip in that first half, the Eagles a little slow out of the gate on both sides of the football. Maybe a rest inside at halftime. They'll come out firing on first down and 10 from their own 21-yard line. Ellison at quarterback will keep and come the near side. Got a block out on the corner. Cuts outside to the 30, up to the 31-yard line.
Close to the first. He dove for it. Not sure that he did get it. Yes, he did. They're going to move the chains. So good play by Ellison to take it around the side there. And good blocking as well. They bid on the inside handoff fake to Breida.
So the Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Receivers break from the huddle. They'll send one to each side. Ellison back with Breida. This time gives it off to Matt. Matt picks up a couple of yards, that's all, to the 34-yard line. Just underway here in the third quarter, 16-13. Georgia Southern with the lead. Let's go down on the field. The Optum Orthopedic Eagle injury update. What do you got, Danny, coming out of the halftime locker room?
Chris, defensive end Logan Hunt is done with an ankle injury. Also, backup linebacker Ken Butler out for the rest of the game with a concussion.
Second down, 8. Ball at the 34-yard line of their very own. They send trip receivers to the right, wide side of the field. Single back in Matt Breida. Now they'll motion Johnson at the snap. Set up the option. Here's the pitch to Breida. Got by one defender. Breaks an arm tackle. 40, 45, 50. Gets to the far sideline. Cuts back middle of the field. Inside the 40. Now it's a cat race to the 30. 25, 20. Angling to the 15, 10, 5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. No flags on the turf. And Matt Breida, with his second rushing touchdown of the night, makes it 22-13, 66 yards, and he ran about 100. Came to the far side, picked up good yardage on the initial run, had blockers out there for him, and then cut back across the grain, and then just outran the Vandals. Couldn't get the angle on him, and Breida into the left corner of the end zone for the 66-yard score. And Alex Hanks trying to add one more here with 13:28 to go. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 23-13, back to a 10-point lead. Matt Breida, 2 rushing touchdowns tonight, 83 and 66 yards. We'll return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. Our score, Georgia Southern 23, Idaho 13. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
Back
fans, the Forum at Statesboro is home to luxury student living right near Georgia Southern. Amenities include indoor basketball courts, sand volleyball, 24-hour fitness center, and much more. Study, live, work, play. They have it all at the Forum at Statesboro. Proud to be official sponsors of Georgia Southern Athletics. 13:28 to go, third quarter action. Eagles take the opening drive, and Matt Breida picks up his 10th touchdown of over 60 yards. That one's 66 yards, running all over the field. Looked like a Madden game with the cheat codes on. He went to the far sideline, then cut it back and outran everybody in the Vandal defensive backfield, angling to the left corner of the end zone. And it's 23-13, and that's just kind of what Matt Breida does on a Saturday night.
I said it was like watching a little Pop Warner football or flag football when they're all over the place. That was crazy. Started on the 22-yard line, three plays. Matt Breida zigzags, dances his way for 66-yard touchdown to extend the 23-13 lead for the Eagles as Young Wei Koo tees it up and gets ready to kick it off. 13-28 here in the third quarter. Domino's Drive Delivery, presented by Domino's, the world leader in pizza delivery, proud sponsor of Georgia Southern Athletics. It's open really late. I know on the East Coast you're listening and watching. So call Domino's and they'll deliver. Go to Domino's.com.
High kick by Young Wei Koo, fielded at the 2-yard line by Aaron Duckworth. Coming near side, caught from behind, and then dropped right at the 17-yard line. Good coverage, a good high kick from Young Wei Koo. No question it had to be returned by Duckworth. And that's where Idaho takes over. First down and 10 with 13:22 to go here in the third quarter. From renowned guest speakers to nationally televised football games to the arts, there's something for everyone at Georgia Southern. Stay connected by following the university on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and others. For a full list of Georgia Southern social media sites, visit georgiasouthern.edu/social. Matt Linehan and the Vandals on the field. First down and 10, ball at the 17-yard line of their own. Linehan steps back, fires, and overthrows his intended receiver, Callan Hightower, up at the 23-yard line. Just sailed that one over. Eagles were in the vicinity, which is a good sign.
Yeah, but for a quarterback, supposedly doesn't have a strong arm. Man, he zipped that ball in there. Joshua Moon made a great tackle on the kickoff for the Eagles. Nice high kickoff by Young Wei Koo.
Defensive substitutions. Eagles get lined up, four-man front. Here's the snap. Second down and 10. Give it off to Penny, and Penny again somehow just moves forward. Looks like he's going to be bottled up at the line of scrimmage, but follows behind the big hogs up front, makes his way to the 25-yard line. Makes third down very manageable. Third and 2 here for the Vandal offense.
Penny over 50 yards with that carry on the night.
If you're the Georgia Southern defense, this is a drive to make a statement. Can't allow the Vandals to stay on the field as the handoff again to Penny, but a flag comes out at the snap. Looks like the Vandals will pick up the penalty. We'll wait and see what it's all about. Should be their third of the night. But if you're the Georgia Southern defense, Terry, the offense came out, answered in the opening drive. Defense has to answer the bell here and really get Idaho to start thinking, hey, we don't win a lot of football games here, and we haven't won two in a row since 2009.
Let's tonight not be the one, and the defense so far has stepped up. They'll probably decline this penalty as the Eagles did shut them down on third down here. It's going to bring a fourth down and 2, and Coach Fritz debating about whether or not to take it or not. And not very happy with the officials for some reason.
Illegal formation, 5 men in the backfield. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Fourth down and 2, and now Idaho's coach is debating here with the ball on their own 25-yard line, and they may go for it here or try to draw Georgia Southern offsides right now.
Coach Petrino may be trying to redeem himself. They did not go for it on fourth and less than a yard for a touchdown back in the first half, going for the field goal, and here.
He does this a lot, though. He likes to go for it.
So it'll be fourth and 2, ball at the 25-yard line. Linehan will move under center. Offset eye formation and play action. Roll the fullback in the flat. Catch made at the 28-yard line near side. It'll be Jake Manley. Great play call, executed to perfection.
Yep.
And Idaho will keep the drive alive.
Yeah, he doesn't get the ball very often, but that was a very good play call. And as you mentioned, well executed. Picked up 10 yards on the play. New set of downs for the Vandals.
Jake Manley, the senior, out of Riggins, Idaho. His fourth catch on the year and his longest of 10 yards. First and 10, now at the 35-yard line. Handoff, right up the gut, Elijah Penny. powers his way to about the 37, maybe just shy of the 38-yard line, under 12 minutes to go third quarter.
Ironhead and De La Rosa on the tackle to both your linebackers. He was able to pick up three.
Clock moving, 11 minutes, 43 seconds. 23-13, Eagles lead by 10. But Idaho and this Vandal offense steadily staying out there in their first drive of the third quarter. Linehan all day. Now will be flushed in trouble. Dropped down at the 25-yard line. Ryan George got his hands on him, would not let go. Linehan could not escape. And George picking up the sack. Big loss on the play for the Vandals.
Yeah, about a 10-yard sack. Good job by Ryan George on that play.
Defensive end, 6'1", redshirt sophomore out of Stevenson High School, Stone Mountain, Georgia. He said he wouldn't be denied.
Maybe a shot in the arm here for this Georgia Southern defense, who again, trying to ring the bell like the offense did in the opening drive of the third quarter on a 66-yard touchdown run for Matt Breida. But Idaho certainly confident going into the halftime locker room, only down by three. And after the sack, looking at third and a cab ride here, back at the 25. Linehan will air it out, seam down the middle, and bobbled and dropped at the Georgia Southern 37-yard line by Buck Cowan, the tight end, junior. Out of Washington State, Chris De La Rosa and Matt Dobson were on coverage. Good thrown ball, though, gave his tight end a chance to haul it in and had it in his hands, just could not hold on.
Certainly did Dobson. Great job playing center field out there. Went over to make the play. It's hard to expect your linebacker, De La Rosa, to stay with him. But he did. But Dobson's key in that one.
Here's where Austin Rico is really a weapon. A chance to even change the field position here if he gets a foot into this one. And he does. High spiraling kick. Keaton calls for the fair catch last moment. Down at the 23-yard line.
Nice punt.
And I tell you what, De La Rosa, those guys just punishing the punt upbacks. They come in with a full set of steam there.
Fans, remember to come out to Nats Landing every Monday night for Inside Georgia Southern Football with your head coach, Willie Fritz, the weekly radio call-in show located just across Fair Road from the banks of beautiful Eagle Creek. Nats is known for its friendly atmosphere. Whether you're a local just visiting, stop by Nats Landing, home of Inside Georgia Southern Football with head coach, Willie Fritz. After the punt, first down and 10 at the 24-yard line, far side hash, L.A. Rams begin as the running back, along with Kevin Ellison in that backfield. Little mess problem, but Ellison eventually holds on, gets positive yards. Up to about the 27, Ed Hall, able to wrap up, maybe a 3-yard gain there, but it almost looked like Ramsby did not want to let go, or Kevin had trouble securing the football before moving forward, but nonetheless, picks up nearly four. It'll be second down and 6. The mark it just inside the 28-yard line of the Eagles.
Very fortunate not to have dropped the ball on that play.
Ellison again working with Ramsby in the backfield. Idaho showing they're coming after it, and they'll set up the option. Ellison fakes the pitch, running downhill far side. 40, 45, 50, heads to the far sideline. Needs one block to spring him free. Still upright, still down the sideline, inside the 20, eventually knocked out of bounds.
Oh,
and we've got a Vandal slow to get up after Ellison absolutely knocked over Dorian Clark on that run. But Kevin Ellison picks up a huge Franklin first down. Huge hole on that right side to spring him free. And then blocking downfield, Miles Campbell trying to set the runway up for Ellison, who eventually runs out of bounds. Just inside the Vandal 20, they'll mark it at the 19-yard line. For the fourth time tonight, the Eagles inside the clubhouse red zone. However, Terry, they're 0-for-3 in the touchdown department, and Georgia Southern overall one of the tops in the country in red zone scores. But as you heard Willie Fritz tell Danny Reed going into the locker room, he wants touchdowns, not field goals.
He does, and we'll take the points, but we need a touchdown in particular against this team. Ellison, just a beautiful read, showing his speed, but also showing his strength, directing his blockers, and had a little Adrian Peterson-like there with his arms as he shed one of the tacklers off and stayed in bounds. That tackler's still on the ground. 53-yard run by Kevin Ellison. Ball's on the 19. 9:48 here to go in the second half. A touchdown would be huge.
Danny down there just away from the injured Vandal, and Danny, it appears they're taking a look at the leg, but now he's going to be helped up, so a good sign.
Yes.
So Dorian Clark still not putting a lot of weight on that leg as he's helped over from the far sideline, coming over to the Vandal bench, helped up by the training crew with 9:48 to play. Eagles huddle up in that far side. Danny, you heard Terry and I talking about it. Coach Willie Fritz, I got to believe in that huddle, is saying, guys, we need to find the end zone. No more kicks.
Well, after a 53-yard run, there's no reason why you can't get 20 in a couple plays. So I think the philosophy is just get downhill. Whoever's going to be handling the ball, just find a way to get over pay dirt and make this a three-score game.
I like his thinking. You know that? Dorian, the young man that was hurt for Idaho, Dorian Clark, is one of the few players outside of or from the South. He's out of Florida, out of Baldwin County High School. Baldwin, Florida. Baldwin High School, I should say, not county.
So the Eagles break from the huddle on the far side. The Vandals do the same. In a TV timeout here with 9:48 remaining in the third quarter. They took it after the injury to Dorian Clark after a 53-yard run by Kevin Ellison.
Seen some highlights here so far tonight that no doubt will make the reels for people to see between two of Breida's runs and then that one, Ellison.
After that 53-yard run, now Ellison closing in on 100 yards tonight. Checking the Vaden-Nissan stat line. Eagles on the night, 334 yards of rushing. Matt Breida, 10 carries, 186, two touchdowns, including that 83-yarder, as I mentioned, now has 10 career touchdowns of 60 yards or more. And Kevin Ellison with 7 carries, and after that 53-yard scamper, now with 92 yards on the night, is L.A. Ramsby back in as the running back. First down and 10 inside the clubhouse red zone at the Idaho 19-yard line. They'll send out Ramsby. Lineup is a wideout right side. Snap to Ellison. Goes B gap right side and makes his way down near the 15-yard line before being stopped there. Gain of 4. It'll be second down and 6. Caden Ellis, the outside linebacker, grabbing Ellison around the waist and pulling him down. James Dean checks out over to the far sideline. Ward back in as the blocking H-back. Keaton will line up as the receiver to the right. Longoria and Johnson. Wideouts to the wide side of the field to the left with 9:04 remaining here in the third quarter. Eagles knocking on the door. Second down and 6 at the Idaho 15-yard line. Here's the snap. Pull from Ellison. Going left side. Tripped up at the shoestrings. Had a huge hole to the left, but Armon Hawkins able to trip up Kevin Ellison.
Wow.
Very similar to the play he ran for 53 yards. It was wide open to the left. Hawkins just dives in and gets him at the ankles.
Huge play for the Eagles here. Third down, just 2 of 6, but as we've talked over and over again, inside the red zone, not able to punch in a touchdown, settling for field goals. The Eagles desperately want this, and this Idaho crowd turns it up a notch as you hear the noise level come up.
So the Eagles will go double tights and an H-back. Ward, Dean, and Rediger in there on the offensive front. Ellison now will motion out, and they'll wildcat. Wild Eagle, direct snap for Ramsby, running behind the offensive line, trying to get his nose to the 10, but he's turned back and stopped at the 11-yard line. He needed the 9 to pick up the first down. It will set up 4th and a little less than 2, but unfortunately, Coach Willie Fritz taking his time here, and he may be thinking about it, and it looks like he will line up to go for it. It will be actually a long 3, 4th and 3, virtually no gain by Ellison last time out, or rather Ramsby. Now Ellison steps back into the pistol. Play clock down to 9 as he stepped up to the offensive line. Play clock down to 5. Motion Dean across the formation left to right. Snaps with 1 on the clock. Hand off Ramsby. Gets to the 9. He's got the first down and carries a pile inside the 5. Down around the 3-yard line, Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Got a little seam, but the rest of that, Terry, all created by L.A. Ramsby, the sophomore out of Cincinnati.
And that run right there started in the weight room. That right there started with the weight room. They had him at the line of scrimmage, and he was able just to keep yanking through it. Those legs just kept powering. Now here the Eagles are knocking at the door.
Eagles were 2 of 2 last week on 4th down conversions. They pick one up there. And now first down, goal to goal at the Idaho 2. Snap, handoff Ramsey, running downhill to his left. Tries to spin off a defender, but then runs into 2 more Vandals, and they'll throw him back. See if they give him forward motion. They threw him back around the 8. It was our man Hawkins again making the tackle. Ramsey spun off the first hit, but ran right into Hawkins. And then his teammates helped clean him up.
Yeah, they gave him the forward progress to the line of scrimmage. Second down is Wesley Fields checks into the ball game.
So now the freshman from America's lines up behind Kevin Ellison. Second down, goal to go from the 2. Eagles trying to punch it in here after converting on fourth down. Snap, handoff, Fields running A-gap, left side, crosses the goal line, put an Eagle six on it, touchdown Georgia Southern. And the freshman Wesley Fields with his second touchdown as an Eagle extends the lead 29-13 with 6:14 to play, and that was a much needed score.
Yes.
For the Georgia Southern Eagles on the road out here in Moscow, Idaho.
We've talked about Wesley Fields as how he reminds us so much of a combination of Breida and L.A. right there. That was the L.A. part.
Alex Hanks on to try to add one more. Matt Dobson to hold. Last week, Ryan Nowicki had the hold duties, but Dobson's done it as well for years. And the kick is up, and the kick is good. So Alex Hanks follows up with a 2-yard touchdown run from Wesley Fields, and the Eagles now extend the lead 30-13 over the Idaho Vandals. Take a timeout, 6:14 remaining, still third quarter action here. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
Eagles here in Moscow, Idaho, 6:14 to play in the third quarter. Russ Brown checking the Spring Hill Suites top 25 scoreboard. Number 9, UCLA all over number 16, Arizona, 49-23 with about 7 minutes to go in that one. Number 17, Northwestern in a ball game with Ball State as the Wildcats lead 24-16 with 7:50 to play in the fourth quarter. The Utah Utes have gone into Outson Stadium and had their way with the Oregon Ducks. They lead that one 41-13 with 7:48 to play in the third quarter. And just underway, number 19, USC out to a 7-0 lead over Arizona State. Chris?
Thank you, Russ. It was a three-point game here at halftime, 16-13. But two possessions for Georgia Southern, one coming very quick, three plays, and 66-yard touchdown run by Matt Breida. And then a more methodical drive, Terry, last time out, with Wesley Fields getting in for his second career touchdown, second of the season, to make it 30-13.
8 plays, 76 yards, 4 minutes and 21 seconds of the clock used, set up by a highlight run by Kevin Ellison of 58 yards. L.A. Ransby showing his strength. Wesley Fields punching it in, but an Eagle 6 on it. The Domino's Drive Delivery presented by Domino's, world leader in pizza delivery, as Youngway Koo kicks it off. Chris, looks to be about 8-9 yards deep in the end zone. They're not going to return it. I know you're out on the East Coast and you're listening to the ball game. Call Domino's or go to Domino's.com. They'll deliver pizza to you even at 11:18 in Statesboro or Macon, Georgia, or Atlanta, Georgia, all parts in between.
Danny, interestingly enough, talking at halftime during the break, it almost appeared that Georgia Southern's team kind of had a little lull in that first half. Things look a lot different offensively and defensively so far here in the third quarter.
Well, the offensive end, they're taking advantage of Idaho being way too aggressive. Their safeties are blitzing from both ends, and we've seen big chunks being broken off. There's going to be plenty more if Idaho doesn't get off the throttle a little bit. Georgia Southern's in prime position.
First down, 10 at the 25. The Vandals come out. Linehan forced out of the pocket to his right, throws as he runs, catch made at the 30-yard line. Deion Watson hauls it in, his tight end makes his way up to the 34 before being spilled out there. Bernard Dawson in the vicinity, and again, Linehan showing his ability, moving the pocket. Has his tight end, flashes numbers, hits him right there, second down and one after a 9-yard pickup. Ball at the 34. They'll go on the ground to Penny. He'll pick up the first down, make his way up to the 39-yard line. Chris De La Rosa in the vicinity that time defensively for Georgia Southern. Sets up a first down for the Vandals. 5 minutes, 33 seconds remain. Third quarter, opening Sunbelt Conference game. The Eagles back-to-back road trips. Fly back early Sunday morning. Take Sunday off. Monday, it's back to the film room, and then Tuesday, preparations to travel to Monroe, Louisiana to take on ULM next Saturday. First down and 10 at the 38. Pass to the flat. Catch made by Penny. Skirts his way up the near sideline, up near midfield. They'll say he was out of bounds at the 47. Just about a 9-yard gain, just shy of another first down for the Vandals.
This is not a Vandal team that seems to go away quietly. Trying to stay with him in the flats is Darius White.
Trip receivers left. Penny the lone back. He'll get the carry. Hit this time, not a lot moving. Got up to the 48, maybe to the 49, and that appears to be enough. only need a yard and a half as Jay Ellison made the tackle. Let's see. If he had to move the chains, he may be just shy as they place that ball down between the 48 and 49-yard line. So it'll be third.
Oh, no.
Let's see. Finally, they move the chains.
Yeah, they're still having an issue over there with the chain gang.
Looked like they made the initial spot at the 49, and they do. Lenahan takes the snap, fires, and this one's going to be incomplete. Flags may come out, and they will. Throwing for Hightower. Cuts inside, the inside route at the 45 of the Eagles. Caleb Williams just made the tackle before the ball arrived.
Pass interference. Defense number 19. Ball be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
14 of 24 on the day so far is Linehan, so he's throwing the ball all over the place.
That pass off the mark, but no question contact made. Fourth penalty of the day against the Eagles. Linehan now with the Vandals on the Eagles' side of the field. At the 44-yard line of the Eagles, first down and 10, 4:25, clock stopped as Linehan steps into the gun. Two receivers right, one to the left side. Here's the snap. Looking right, airs this one out into double coverage, looking for Epps, and he hauls it in for the score. Made the catch down around the five, and Linehan needled it between two Eagle defenders. But Epps got a step on him, and his second receiving touchdown of the night.
44-yarder in between two defenders, and if you're watching the replay on that one, you hear people talk about the term of ball hawk, going for the ball. That particular play, neither one of our defenders went for the ball, and it fell right into the cradle, didn't it? Really a beautiful pass.
So the Vandals not going away in the night. Rico comes on for the point after, and it's good. It's a 10-point game once again, third time tonight, 30-20. Georgia Southern with the lead. But Matt Linehan continues to light up the stat book. Now 15 of 25, well over 200 yards passing, and two passing touchdowns to his favorite target, Desmond Epps. And Epps has been a controversial character here at Idaho, coming out of Sacramento, California. Missed all of last season due to a suspension with a theft off campus. And then on August 16th of this year, there was a video that surfaced from shoplifting at the campus store here at the University of Idaho. He was identified on that film and was forced to sit in the game against USC in the second week of the season, although many people wondering how many chances Coach Petrino is going to give Desmond Epps. And, you know, based on his performance here tonight, six catches, 155 yards, and two touchdowns, there's a reason that Coach Petrino giving him a benefit of the doubt.
He may not have been able to outrun some of his legal issues, but he's certainly outrunning our defensive back. Six catches on the day, 155 yards, two touchdowns, a long of 60, and he had another one now of 44.
Here's the kick by Rico. Another high, hangs in the air, 2 yards deep. Keaton will bring it out. Coming up the far side hash, a little bit of room, then knocked down as he makes it to the 30-yard line. May have got to the 31. And with 4:12 to play, Eagles get ready to scrimmage once again on offense, leading 30-20. Fans, Queensboro National Bank and Trust, when you're ready to acquire, call the Q. They have 22 branches across the state of Georgia. Stop in and you'll say, the Q works for me. Queensboro National Bank and Trust, equal housing lender, member FDIC, Fabian Upshaw. Coming for the third time tonight, run the offense here. Coach Doug Ruse and head coach Willie Fritz. Matt Breida will be in the backfield at running back. Two receivers to the left, one to the right side, short side of the field as they scrimmage. Attacking right to left on your dial. Here's the snap. Upshaw going to try to stretch the field, and running out of room is going to be brought down at the 32, maybe just shy of the 33. Armon Hawkins again, a sophomore safety at Rancho Cucamonga, California. Staying step for step for Upshaw and eventually bringing him down.
Glad I don't have to say where he's from. Very good speed shown right there by Idaho. Pretty tough to catch Upshaw on the perimeter like that.
Move the ball to the near side hash. He'll send trip receivers to the right. Williams, Johnson, and Keaton. Upshaw steps into the pistol. Breida on his hip to the left side. James Dean in, has the blocking H-back. Here's the snap, option, and Idaho blows it up. They were on Upshaw as he pitched, and they cut down Breida at the 25-yard line. Armon Hawkins, who's playing lights out defensively from the safety position. Huge loss on the play. Will make it third and long upcoming for the Eagles.
Sometimes you look at that and wonder if they picked up on a tendency, because they came in with a major blitz there on the corner right where we were running it, and then the corner came up hard just to take him out. We didn't have a chance to get a block on him. He said that's what happened a little bit at West Virginia, where we had tipped him off on something. They were able to pick up on it.
3:05 remaining. Eagles 2 of 7 on third down. It's a big one here, third and 15. Upshaw. Option. Pitch to Johnson. Idaho has it covered up. Trying to turn direction and field. Nowhere to go. And he's brought down, this time at the 23-yard line. Another loss. It'll be 4th and 17. The Eagles will have to punt. And Danny down there on the sidelines. Terry mentioned it. Idaho seems to be in the huddle. They've been there the last two big plays for big losses.
What they've started doing with this safety pressure, whenever Georgia Southern motions that slot receiver, they're bringing pressure from that area. And unfortunately, the last two times, it's been right where the pitch is designed to go.
Matt Flynn out to punt, Chris. It looks like Matt Flynn, at least. Can't tell.
Flynn to punt it away. Stands at the 9-yard line. Desmond Epps, the speedster receiver. Low snap. Flynn gets it away, but not a great kick. Takes a high Georgia Southern bounce at the 45. Another good bounce inside the 40. And the Eagles will down it, keep it away from Epps. And they'll start at the 33-yard line of their very own. But Idaho trying to make a battle here with 1:59 to go in the third quarter. Trailing Georgia Southern 30-20. With a lot of confidence defensively, and more than likely, after a 40-yard strike from Linehan to Epps, this offense got another pep in their step as well.
Momentum, just like last year, shifting in Idaho's favor. We saw that happen in the third quarter last year. We were able to squash it. And this team with Idaho is certainly playing with some swagger, a little smack talk, and a little bit of everything with confidence.
First down and 10 at the 34-yard line. Idaho ready to go. Shotgun snap to Linehan. Give to Penny, left side. Bounces off the tacklers, makes his way up to the 38-yard line. Gain of 4, second down and 6 upcoming.
Penny getting closing in on 70 yards himself. As we mentioned, he had 200 yards of rushing, not he, the team 200 yards of rushing last week against Wofford.
Second down and 6, ball at the 38-yard line. Keep it on the ground. Penny looking for a hole, stood up as he got to the 40 and thrown back there. They'll say he got to the 41-yard line. Pickup of 3. That'll make it 3rd down and 3 upcoming for this Vandal offense with a minute 19 to go in the third quarter. And something tells me a lot of candles burning on that East Coast.
Yep.
So we hit 11:30, coming up on 11:30 Eastern time.
He ran into Antoine Williams, the wall there. In this play, you mentioned they like to go underneath, look for your Epps guy. He's pretty talented there, obviously. He showed what he could do tonight.
3rd down and 3, under a minute to play, third quarter. Trip receivers right. Penny the lone back. Looking for the slant. Epps had it in his hands and drops it at the 50-yard line.
Wow.
Darius Jones on coverage. That one ripped in there by Linehan.
I'll be surprised if they punt here. And they are going to. But he fired that ball in there. And he may not have been able to get it in had he not thrown it as hard as he did.
Well, on 4th and 3, Coach Petrino, after his defense blew up the Eagles' offensive effort last time out, willing to play field position with a great punter in Austin Rico, who can pin the Eagles back here.
Or a fake.
Keaton back deep, stands at the 15. Snap, and it will be a fake. Rico throwing down the field and incomplete at the 40-yard line. Had a man open. That time, Darius White on coverage pulled up a little too soon, was out of position. They were looking for Will Smith near the near sideline and hit him right in the face mask.
They did. I thought, well, we jumped up to try to defend it there. Aye, boy. Yeah, if it works, you great play call. When it doesn't, it's what everybody else is thinking.
So instead of playing field position, they give the Eagles a short field now. 1st down and 10. At the Idaho 42-yard line with 41 seconds remaining.
That
big his special team's been tonight. Huge.
So the Eagle offense on the field. Kevin Ellison, along with L.A. Ramsby. Give to L.A. Trying to find something off the right edge. Trying to move the pile. Got about half a yard. That's all.
Man, they are crashing from the corner over there. Idaho literally walking up that corner. Jordan.
Down to 20 seconds remaining, third quarter. Eagles in no hurry here. Play clock yet to begin.
Correction, Kendrick Trotter coming up hard, just crashing down, just like we saw Glover do on the goal line stand for the Eagles earlier. And we're going to let it go.
So the Eagles will decide to let the third quarter come to an end. They'll switch sides of the field. And 15 minutes remain here in Moscow, Idaho. 30-20, Eagles lead. They'll have it second and nine at the Idaho 41-yard line when we return. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Georgia Southern football proudly supported by Zaxby's. In your neighborhood, Zaxby's restaurant. Zaxby's, indescribably good for over 20 years. We start the fourth quarter of action here in Moscow, Idaho. Eagles up 30-20. Vandals decide to gamble on a fake punt. Had the Eagles dead to rights. But a drop pass down at the Eagle 40-yard line. Eagles take over on downs. Now look at second and nine from the Vandal 41-yard line. Checking the Baden-Nissan stat line. Both teams doing what they do best. Idaho, 333 yards total offense, 250 of that through the air. Georgia Southern, 433 yards total offense, 346 on the ground, including Matt Breida, 11 carries, 179 yards, two touchdowns. Kevin Ellison, 9 carries, 99 yards so far. Interesting move on 4th and 3 to go for the fake punt.
Yeah.
Get over that.
But I'm glad he did, and I'm glad it worked out in our favor. L.A. Ramsby checking in at the back.
Ellison calling for the snap. Two receivers left, one to the right. Play action. Ellison has time. Throws this one down the seam and caught. B.J. Johnson hauls it in down at the 5-yard line.
He's down. A little bit of a wind probably knocked out of him. He landed.
An absolute strike offered up by Kevin Ellison. Right down the middle of the field, Johnson coming across on the post and hauls it in, but takes a hard hit to the turf. And they'll come out to take a look at him here, but a huge play sets up the Eagles on the Franklin first down. First down goal to go at the Idaho 5.
He has made, that's the third big-time catch that he's made. There was so much about him coming in, his off-season workout in the weight room and on the field. He just got bigger but seemed to get faster. And he had a few hiccups in the first game, but I think it might have been jitters. He showed his hands, and when he came down with that catch, it might have hurt his shoulder there. But it's his fourth catch for 93 yards with a long of 36. So he's averaging 23.3 yards per catch as he's up on his feet, but it might be his shoulder, just like Breida had.
The irony there is he beat Hawkins to the football, and Hawkins, who really disrupted the Eagle offense last time, blitzing in the backfield, that time had to play coverage, and B.J. Johnson just muscled it away and had better position. And again, it looks like the shoulder a little tender for B.J. Johnson. Second time he's had to come out of the game. Hopefully he'll be all right. Danny will get a check on him from the training crew coming up. But more importantly, for the Eagles, fifth trip inside the clubhouse red zone. Now first down, goal to go at the Idaho 5. Last time Wesley Fields able to punch it in. L.A. Ramsby out there as the running back. Kevin Ellison, pistol snap, sets up speed option. Ellison has the seam. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. The defense just parted, and Kevin Ellison made that one look easy. It's 36-20, 14-25 to go here in the fourth quarter as Ellison eclipses 100 yards rushing and picks up his third rushing touchdown of the season.
Set up by a 36-yard great catch by B.J. Johnson. And that one, they didn't decide which one to take. Ellison
or L.A.
Hanks trying to add one more. Low snap. Dobson, though, gets it up. Laces out. Kick is up. And the kick is good. 37-20. 17-point lead. 14:25 to go in the game. That's the answer the Eagle offense needed. Again, set up by a beautiful pass. For the most part, Ellison's passes tonight have been right on the money, although just 5 of 13. The throws down the field have been pretty good. In fact, he's thrown for 101 yards.
Low snap again on the extra point. Seen two of those tonight. Dobson doing a very good job of getting it up. And Alex Hanks did a fantastic job of staying focused and concentrating, Danny, on that and making his kicks.
Dobson did a heck of a job to get that ball to a point where it was actually perpendicular with the ground. He actually ended up putting his right hand completely on top of the ball so he didn't lose full grip. The kick was a knuckler, but fortunately it found its way through.
Fans, remember Walker Pharmacy, free in-town delivery, online refill options, even text alerts letting you know when your prescription is ready. It's your town, your pharmacy, your choice. Walker Pharmacy, three locations to serve you, the official pharmacy of Georgia Southern Athletics. 14:25 to go in the ballgame. Jackson Morris, or Youngway Koo, rather, come out to kick it away. Penny and Duckworth back deep for the Vandals. Here's the approach. Youngway line drive kick. Takes a nasty bounce over the head of Penny and then the back of the end zone. It'll be a touchback. Penny, though, picks it up.
Ooh.
And don't know if he knew what to do. It did not go out of the back of the end zone. It took a bounce at about the 7, went over the head of Penny, and then just died in the back of the end zone. He eventually goes and tracks it down. Luckily, nothing bad happens.
That'll be a teachable moment for Coach Petrino. They watch the films. And again, folks, Idaho has the ability to score quickly, as we've seen that tonight. 60-yard touchdown pass, 44-yard touchdown pass. You know they can. So 37-20 is still, with 14:21 to go in this ballgame, is not a safe lead by any means.
Idaho breaks the huddle. First down and 10 at their own 25. And now we have a halt in play and a whistle from the far sideline. Side judge blows the whistle. We'll run over and talk to our referee. We'll see what the halt is all about. Side judge Bart Horn talking with Kevin Stein, our referee.
Pretty good job so far tonight of officiating. Yes, I know it. Mark that down, but I said that.
So whatever the discussion was, they now get set. Play clock begins to move. They'll try first down and 10 from the 25. Lenahan motions. Quick pitch coming near side. Duckworth with room across the 30. Bounced out of bounds at about the 32. Chris De La Rosa slow to get up. But works himself up on his own power.
Pretty good call. We even had 8 on the line of scrimmage at that particular play. But we closed quickly. The speed later in the game is really becoming evident.
13:56, just underway in the fourth quarter. 7-yard gain, second down and 3. Lenahan looking for Epps, coming back to the football. He was shielded off that time by Darius Jones. The Vandals want pass interference, but unfortunately the throw was underthrown. And Epps tried to fight through Darius Jones to come back to it.
And this is not the NFL. So, doesn't have to turn around, even though I wish he would, because it had been an interception. Had he tried to turn around and make a play on it, it would have been offensive pass interference.
So, third down and 3. 1 of 8 tonight for the Vandals. And before the snap, got a timeout taken by Georgia Southern. So, they'll burn their first timeout of the second half, 2 remaining. Coach Fritz not happy with the alignment there on a very important third down and 3 here with a lifetime left in this game, even though the Eagles lead by 17.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may have noticed earlier that we didn't show the names of our platinum members of the quarterback club.
Go down to Danny Reed. He's got an optomorthopedic Eagle injury update. Status on B.J. Johnson. Danny?
Chris, the right shoulder was put in a black sling. He has been taken to the locker room to get an x-ray. Return is questionable.
tough break for BJ, who's had a tremendous game here tonight. Terry mentioned, four reception, 93 yards, including on that last drive, a 36-yard catch to set up the score by Kevin Ellison. Fans, your chance to pick our Georgia Power Player of the Game. Tell you how you can be involved coming up after this next play on third down. We'll announce the winner in the Ford locker room wrap-up. Third and three at the 32-yard line. Lenahan puts Penny on the wing to the right side. Two receivers left, one to the right. Matt Dobson cheating up at the line. Now Lenahan, drag route to the wide of the tight end. Intercepted by the Eagles. Jay Ellison stepped right in front of it. Pulled it out of the air. And Lenahan offers up the INT. Huge turnover. First of the night for the Vandals. And Lenahan under a lot of duress when he released it. Thrown just behind his intended receiver, the tight end Buck Cowan. And Jay Ellison, the big guy. Nice hands, the junior out of Hamilton, Georgia. Gets his first interception, sets up the Eagles in fine fashion at the 32-yard line of Idaho.
How many 305-pound defensive backs have you seen? Beautiful play by Ellison and a beautiful play call by Coach Curtis. Stunt there, what we did was we had a four-man rush. We walked up our linebackers showing blitz, and on the blitz, Ellison steps back to get in the passing lane. The quarterback saw it happen before, was able to dump it there. This time we make the adjustment, pick it off.
Ellison takes the snap on first down, throws the screen far side. Keaton trying to find the blockers, and eventually the Vandals bring him down. The ball comes out on the far sideline, and Idaho picks it up at the 27. So the Eagles give it right back on the fumble, trying to set up the screen, and Idaho back in business.
Give it right back to him, trying to get some extra yardage, trying to fight for more, and Idaho doing a very good job. Campbell out there doing a great job of blocking for him, and like I said, he's just trying to get more and more, and he just got stripped. Great heads-up play by Idaho on that play. Linebacker, I believe, came in and pulled it away.
So the second turnover by the Eagles, an interception early in the first half.
Chris Edwards, the linebacker Chris Edwards came in there. He was able to yank it away. So both teams now have two turnovers each, if I'm not mistaken.
Looks like it'll go under review to see if the ball stayed in play. It was tied over there on that far boundary at around the 30-yard line. A couple of Vandals had their feet on the boundary, and they may have to determine who came up with the fumble and if the ball ever went out of bounds. So the play is under review. They'll go up to the booth. Replay official again, Bill Merritt. So under review here inside the Kibbe Dome.
All right, we watch it again. He clearly has it stripped. Can't tell if the ball went out of bounds or was touched, and it may have been. What they're looking at is, did he kick it back inbounds, and then they jump on it? It has to be clear, and I can't tell from here.
I'd like to have a break here, though. That'd be nice.
I think Danny had a better view of it on that far sideline. Danny, what'd you see?
The ball was batted back in by 21, Jordan Grabski. It looked to, from my vantage point, that he could have been out of bounds. But if you go to the video and look, it's hard to tell whether he was out of bounds because the video's from across the field.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
They couldn't tell either. If you can't get a clear override, I get it. The camera angle over there. As we watch the play, again, linebacker made a great play of stripping it from him. And to Danny's point, was he out of bounds when he was batting it back in? And it's hard to tell. And may have been falling out of bounds, but it doesn't matter at this point.
So, first and 10 at the 28-yard line. Lenahan and company with 13:28 to play, down 37-20.
Looking for a quick strike, so you got to look, find where Ebbs is.
Lined up as the wideout to the near side. Snap to Lenahan, looking for his receiver. Catch made on the slant.
Wow.
Up at the 35-yard line. Mwella hauls it in, his third catch of the night.
And he fired that ball in there. It's going to be second one.
Clock moving, 13:10 and counting. Still a long time left in this fourth quarter.
Riyadh Jones was step for step with Epps.
Handoff. give it to Penny. And Penny got the first down and then some up to the 49-yard line. Pick up of 13 on the ground. First down for the Vandals.
12:58 to go in this game.
Ready to get back to work. Linehan calls for the snap. Swings it near side. Penny catch at the 45. Makes his way to midfield. Drop there. Only a gain of a yard. Antoine Williams covers him up defensively.
Darius White in there to help bring him down. And with this quick offense like that, it's hard for the Eagles to substitute. Lindy Richardson able to get in the ball game. That's the only substitution. Four-man front, three linebackers. You got Ryan George in there, defensive end.
Second and nine, ball right at midfield. Linehan on the keeper, coming near side, has room, takes a hard hit as he makes it to the 43. Antoine Williams got a piece of it. Linehan pops up. He's been a durable cat all evening, and he's taken some shots, throwing the football, and that time running. They go to a hurry-up mode here, third and two. Here's the snap. Give to Penny. Hit behind the line. Don't think he got the lunge he needed. Antoine Williams got to him first.
Dobson comes flying in there, trying to strip it at the same time. Also, Jamal Johnson, junior out of Statesboro, Southeast Bullock, making a big play. Fourth down and one. You know they're going to go for it.
They'll try to beef up the front here.
We're trying to get substitutions in.
Linehan, maybe for the third time tonight in short yardage situation, he will go under center. Offset eye formation. Fourth down and a yard. The give to Penny, hit behind the line and dropped. Did not get it. Chris De La Rosa fires through the line, wraps him up, and Matt Dobson cleans him up. And that should be the second turnover on downs for the Idaho Vandals. Great stop defensively for Georgia Southern. Great play by De La Rosa and Dobson.
Great penetration by the guys up front, too. They were able to crash the gaps, push them back. Jamal Johnson had just called him out, and he did it again. Great job.
Timeout on the field, 11:38 to go. Eagles hold on to a 37-20 lead. They get the football back. Turnover on downs. It'll be first and 10 at the 42-yard line of their very own. We'll return to the Kibbe Dome in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, portions of tonight's game presented by Vision Source. Dr. Ben Watson at the Watson Eye Center in Savannah. Get your appointment today, 912-352-9356, Vision Source, the official team eye doctor of Georgia Southern Athletics. 11:38 to go, fourth quarter action, 37-20. Georgia Southern with a 17-point lead. You still get a sense, Terry, with that time, 11 and a half minutes, over 11 and a half minutes, the way Idaho has had the quick strike capability and really showing no fear, playing with a lot of confidence here on their home field, that the Eagles still need to keep their foot on the gas.
We're waiting to see which quarterback's going to come into the ball game right now. And Ellison is in. He's just back. De La Rosa, by the way, leading tackler tonight. Nine tackles, eight solos. That one was huge.
First down and 10 at the 42-yard line. Breida back in as the running back as well. Ellison on first down. Takes the high snap. Hands it off to Breida. Breida got hit as he made his way just shy of the 44-yard line. Set up second down and nine.
Timbers flaring a little bit out there on the Idaho side. Hopefully they won't do anything unnecessary. Wesley Fields checks into the ball game alongside of Breida, both of them in the backfield.
Second down, nine. Mark it just shy of the 44-yard line. They'll go to twin backs now. Wesley Fields, Matt Breida will surround Kevin Allison. We'll send one receiver to each side. Eagles taking their time here, watching the clock move as Ellison keeps it himself, steps inside, jitterbugs away from a defender, across midfield and brought down at the 47-yard line of the Vandals. Jordan Grabski had to grab him. Otherwise, Ellison gets free for another big gainer, but a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles puts him in business on the Vandal side of the field. With 10:44 clock moving here in the fourth quarter.
Nice read by Ellison again. Both he had Fields and Breida in the backfield at the time with him, now just Fields. But Ellison, over 100 yards on the day, averaging almost 10.5 yards per carry.
First down, 10 at the 47. Far side hash, attacking left to right. Ellison gives it to Fields. He'll cover up the football, drive right through the heart of the Vandal defense, make his way down to the 45-yard line before Chris Edwards able to make the stop. 2-yard gain sets up second down and 8. Eagles again ready and willing to let that clock move. 10-13 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Trying to pick up their first Sun Belt Conference win of the season. On the road, 2,100 miles away from home here in Moscow, Idaho. Under 10 minutes. Eagles in no hurry. Play clock down to 15. Break from the huddle. Looking at second and 8. The Vandal 45. Trip receivers to the right. Give to Fields. Big hole and up the far side hash inside the 40 before being tripped up there about the 38-yard line by Quentin Bradley, defensive end.
What does that say for your confidence? And you're at the end of the ball game here, there's plenty of time. You're losing the turnover battle, and you're willing to put it in the hands of a freshman. You know, that shows a lot of confidence, but you can see why, the way he grips that ball.
Coach Fritz has said it time and time again, one of the most mature freshmen he has ever coached in 23 years in football in Wesley Fields. Third down and a yard, just shy of the 38-yard line. They'll give to Wesley again. Counter run, breaks a tackle at the 30, tries to get to the far side inside the 20, picks up the Franklin first down. Finally spilled down at about the 17, just shy of the 16-yard line before Jordan Grabski makes the tackle. But inside the clubhouse red zone once again are the Eagles with 8:51 to go here in the fourth quarter.
Nice run. Good strength. Fields on the night. He's on 30 yards. I'm sorry. Check that.
8:29. First down at 10 at the 17-yard line. Ellison takes the snap. Give to Fields. Bounces off his own man and then stutter steps his way inside the 15 down to around the 13-yard line. Pick up a 4. Hard yards for the freshman out of Americus. Clock continues to move. 8:09. Eagles keeping it on the ground here and eating up 4 and 5 yards a clip.
I was looking at his receiving yards as Ellie Ramsby comes in to give him a break. I'd like to see L.A. punch one in.
7:50 remaining in the game. 37-20, Georgia Southern leads. Second down and 6 now at the 13-yard line inside the clubhouse red zone. The Eagles would like to put it on ice here. Ellison, handoff, Ramsby off the left side. Just kind of backpedals his way down near the 12-yard line. Not much doing there. Sets up 3rd and 5. Caden Ellis, the outside linebacker, never letting go of L.A. Ramsby.
No, he never had his footing either. He just didn't look comfortable when he got that ball from Ellis. 3rd down and 5 ball at the 14. The clock's ticking down at 7:15 and counting. And the Vandal fans here are turning it up a notch, saying go crazy, trying to get this ball back.
It's a 3rd and a short 6 here with the ball just inside the 13-yard line. Far side hash. Ellison trying to convert. Ellison to pull. Ellison with room. Far edge. Got blockers. 10-5 and bounces his way into the end zone. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Ellison, the second time tonight, finds Pater. And a great job out on the left edge. It was really an open runway for Ellison. Had a man cut down, and then it was all the way, finding his way across the goal line, make it 43-20 with 6:51 remaining in the fourth quarter. Alex hangs on for one more.
Nowicki on the hold this time for Georgia Southern, and we come back and we'll talk about Jeff Ward's block.
Kick is up, and the kick is good. 44-20, Georgia Southern stretching its legs here. 6:51 to go in the fourth and final quarter. We'll take a timeout. We'll return in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. .651 remains here in Moscow, Idaho, and the Eagles up 44-20. Last year, of course, 47-24 with the final score back in Statesboro. But this one a little bit tighter for quite a bit of this game, and Idaho not backing down in the third quarter, but things starting to unravel for Coach Petrino and company here in the fourth stanza. Eagles will kick it back to the Vandals. Checking the Baden Nissan stat line, the Eagles now 535 yards of total offense. This Vandal team so far on the year giving up 541 yards a game. The Eagles closing in on that average. They've got 408 through the Eagles on the ground on 44 carries. Matt Breida leading the way, 12 carries, 190 yards, 83 is long, two rushing touchdowns. Kevin Ellison eclipses 100 yards on 12 carries, 128 yards. Here's the kick. Youngway Koo puts a foot in it, and this time out of the back of the end zone for good. It's a touchback, and the Vandals start first down at 10 at their own 25. Time now. You to be involved in the broadcast. Pick our Georgia Power Player of the Game. Kevin Ellison, as I mentioned, really back to the Kevin Ellison we're used to. 12 carries, 128 yards, 6 of 14 passing. Did have the interception early in the first half. But if you think Kevin Ellison is the player of the game, text GS1 to 90561. That's GS1 to 90561. For Matt Breida, another great night. Text GS2 to 90561. And defensively, Matt Dobson. Text GS3 to 90561. Your vote for the Georgia Power player of the game. First down and 10 at the 25, Matt Linehan. Long way to go, short time to get there, and on first down, under duress, rolls to his right, fires out, his escape valve has it at the 30-yard line. Buck Cowan, the tight end, give him a 5-yard gain. He wanted to go deep, but good coverage down the field. He had to come back to his tight end, completes the pass.
Yes, Glover doing a good job back there with Darius White staying back.
Don't let anybody behind you.
Coach Fritz wanted to address that at halftime. For the most part here in the second half, they've done a much better job. Epps, short stuff at the 36. Hauls it in, hit immediately by Antoine Williams. But it's enough for a Vandal first down. So Epps, normally the speedster down the field, going for something underneath. Linehan able to hit him.
Yeah, let him have it underneath. It's eating up clock. Not getting burned with a quick touchdown.
First down and 10, now up at the 37-yard line of their own. Eagles, again, have done a great job disguising blitz. This time they back off. This time thrown and incomplete up at the 45. They were looking for Deion Watson. And that one rifled a little too hard. Deshante Gallen was cheating up on the line, and after the snap, kind of fell back in coverage to fill up the middle of that field. Linehan looking for Watson. Too much on it. It's incomplete. Sets up second down 10 at the 37-yard line. Epps in the slot. He's been the star receiver. This time they'll hand it off, and Elijah Penny cutting the right side makes his way to the 41, just shy of the 42 before Antoine Williams pulls him down. It'll be third down and a short six upcoming.
Interesting play call.
Penny has had the majority of totes tonight.
He's done a good job.
21st carry. Duckworth just 3 carries tonight. Duckworth very pivotal in the win last week over the Wofford Terriers, having 3 rushing touchdowns, 8 yards, 10 yards on 2 occasions. 3rd and 5, Linehan throws to the flat. Long pass to the near side. It's complete at midfield to the Eagle 49. Desmond Epps, good hands. Just outran the coverage, and Caleb Williams couldn't keep up with him, but a heck of a throw by Matt Linehan across the field.
Guys, very impressive. 19-33, 275, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception. That one exactly where he needed it.
1st and 10. Now at the Eagle 49-yard line, we're under 5 minutes remaining. Penny with the carry, runs right side, and has room. Breaking and shedding arm tackles, makes his way to the 41 before Ironhead Gallen comes in to stop the play.
Rolled on Dobson's left ankle. He's getting up hobbling. Hopefully he'll be okay. They're going to get a replacement in for him. Looks like Moon's going to come in, and you want to talk about a bruising hitter, Joshua Moon. He's played safety but linebacker like Ironhead.
8-yard gain by Penny. Sets up second down and two. Now at the Eagle 41, Linehan looking right. Comeback route, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. Running down the field, Caleb Williams eventually brought down at midfield. And another turnover for the Idaho Vandals. That'll be interception number two. And Caleb Williams able to make the play, step right in front of the passing route, picks up his first interception of the season. And that may be all she wrote for the Idaho Vandals. Timeout on the field, 4:10 remaining. Eagles up 44-20 on a late night. Just after the midnight hour on the East Coast. We'll return in just a moment. Finish this one out. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans at ServPro Statesboro, no job is too big and no question too small. Their team of specialists are faster to any size disaster. That's ServPro of Statesboro, helping make fire and water damage like it never happened. A proud supporter of Georgia Southern football. 4:10 remains here inside the Kibbe Dome. While we have a moment, let's pause 10 seconds. Station identification. Some great stations along the network can identify themselves. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Our score. Georgia Southern leads over Idaho, looking to pick up their first conference win of the season, move to 3-1 on the year, and then make a trip over to Louisiana coming up next weekend, taking on ULM. Welcome back to the Kibbe Dome. Chris Blair, Terry Harmon, Danny Reed, Colin Lacey, Russ Brown, Frank Sokowski out there in the crowd doing his work. Of course, Drew Whaley on controls back at Network Studio. Eagles take over after the interception. Wesley Fields will be the running back. The freshman lines up just behind Kevin Ellison. Kevin has a little trouble at the mesh and then keeps it and somehow makes a play out of it. That's Mr. Improv. Jordan Grabski gets him down, not before he gets inside the 45 to the 43-yard line.
Got to be careful with that one. Ellison saw a gap, and he was like just yanked it out and took it out. Y'all, if you get a chance, while we got him in. If you go back and find the replay of Jeff Ward, because I got to give this guy some love here, you got to look at that block. If you're an offense, aspiring offensive lineman, that technique right there is what you need to follow. That block was unbelievable a couple plays back.
Took him all the way out to the cheap seats on that far sideline.
Yeah, I see the guy's still up in the stands eating popcorn, I think.
First down and 10. Ellison give to Fields, and Fields has some running room. Down to the 36-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Jordan Grabski again. Makes the tackle.
Wesley Fields going to check out of the ball game. Coming in is going to be Chaz Thornton. I know Chaz is looking for a little redemption. If you remember what happened last week at the Citadel. Broke off a 40-something yard gallop and wasn't able to hold on to it around the 1-yard line. But Chaz Thornton certainly very impressive. Young running back.
Monte Crockett will line up as a receiver far side to the left. Chaz Thornton in there, as Terry mentioned. Ellison takes the snap, gives it to Thornton. Thornton just drops his helmet, makes his way to the 35-yard line.
Timeout called by Idaho. Salvage some of this clock with 2:38 to go in this ballgame.
So the Eagles looking to go 3-0 all time against Idaho. As I said, more importantly, picking up their first conference win of the season. Vegas Harley checking in just before that timeout taken. Get some action at quarterback. And Danny, you had a chance to talk to Coach Fritz going in at the half. And no concern, but certainly didn't like what he saw in that first half. Wanted to make some adjustments and a little better execution. And overall, I think he'll be pleased with the second half of action.
When you've got veterans, especially at the skill positions, with Ellison, with Upshaw, with Breida, with Ramsby, you can even say now with Fields getting as much time as he has gotten the last couple of weeks, they're going to know how to adjust on the fly. Ellison's been great this half. Breida had the phenomenal run to start the second half. And, of course, the big fourth down stop and on that fake punt as well.
So Harley takes the snap, gives it to Chaz Thornton. Thornton trying to make his way back to the line of scrimmage. stop there. And again, Petrino calling for a timeout with 2:31.
Might as well use him if he got him.
Stops the clock for 2 minutes and 31 seconds. So it appears Kevin Ellison done for the day. 13 carries, 134 yards, 2 rushing touchdowns. 6 of 14 passing, 105 yards. Had that one interception early on in the opening drive.
The Eagles, 423 yards rushing so far on the night. 550 yards of total offense. Not too bad as the Eagles get, I know we got 231, but, first game in defending the Sun Belt title. Get ready to go on the road again to Louisiana, take on Louisiana Monroe. And round two with them. Hopefully Eagle Nation, a little bit of a closer trip than this one. They don't have potatoes, though.
Third down and 9. Fresh faces getting a chance here. This time, Harley going to keep it on the left edge. Cuts back in. Got a block he needed at the 30, inside the 25, and dropped at the 21-yard line. And a great run by Vegas Harley, who certainly can do it on the ground. Picks up the Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles as the clock rolls under 2.5 minutes.
Nice speed by Vegas Harley. We know he has it. Wish we could figure out a way to work him in the offense in a different position just so he's on the field. It's electrifying to watch. Banks into the ball game at the running back position. Thomas Banks, we talk about, the get out of Augusta Christian.
So Harley on first down gives it to Banks. Banks runs into a wall right up the middle. Stop at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Sets up second down and 10. Coming up, the Ford locker room wrap up. So stay with us as we are now officially into Sunday morning on the East Coast.
Right. One of my favorites in the ballgame, Noah Hickey. Like that kid.
Ford locker room wrap up. Russ Brown. Take you through the game stats, game highlights. Later on, Terry Harbin and Russ will take your tweets and comments about tonight's game. Stay up late with us on the East Coast. Second down, 10. Ball at the 21-yard line. Hickey will get the carry. Ran into a wall at the line. Now trying to bounce it outside to the right. Eventually dropped at the 24-yard line. Ramon Hawkins again able to do a good job in run coverage. Making the tackle and loss on the play of 4. They'll set up 3rd and 13 here.
It's tough for Noah as coach is rotating in the running backs to try to get everybody some playing time and getting the multiple carries fast. Like Thornton's back into the ball game. Chaz Thornton.
So the young Eagles will get a chance here on 3rd and 13. Harley, give it to Thornton. Almost had it free. Had a hole inside the 20. Stopped it around the 18-yard line. A gain of 6. Ed Hall making the tackle, the backup outside linebacker.
Good blocking by Jackson Morris, 6'1", 270 sophomore out of Kennesaw.
And that'll probably be all she wrote. 13 seconds remain on the game clock. Final 10 seconds will roll off. The Eagles will watch the clock. The Vandals now making their way onto the field. Coach Willie Fritz. Coach Petrino will meet at midfield. The horn sounds, and this one's in the books. And the Eagles pick up their first conference win of the season on the road in Moscow, Idaho. Final score 44-20 over the Idaho Vandals. The Eagles do a great job taking control of the game midway through the third quarter. Then held on and did not look back in the fourth and final stanza. So the Eagles move to 3-1 on the season. For the Idaho Vandals, they fall to 1-3. More importantly, Georgia Southern off to a 1-0 start in the Sun Belt. Idaho 0-1. Eagles on the road next week to take on ULM in Monroe, Louisiana. It doesn't get easier for the Vandals. They will travel to take on Arkansas State in Jonesboro. A week from now. Final score here inside the Kibbe Dome. Georgia Southern 44, Idaho 20. Much more coming your way. Stay with us. We'll return to Moscow, Idaho in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.